mid and defend mid. They've just not been successful with that at all.
Here comes the big Uber play. Looks like they're gonna go from Roller Door again. Popping early here, it's Costin with Ryder and Walker. They're trying to find this Ryzen right hand side. They kill off Avery. Now they're turning their attention to the left, but they've already lost three despite having that huge Uber advantage, and they're totally horrendously overcommitted here. It's desperate situation right now, but it's all an FD to try and find that medic, but he gets the rocket and sends Tom to the spawn queue. And wow, I think we've just seen the green shoots recovery here from Donata boys. Believe, 20 believe.
That was a hell of a lot better of a defense than last time. They kited the Uber perfectly, they saw it coming on right, they moved the majority of their combo over to left-hand side, and the rest of the team just backed into spawn. And they really didn't, Citroën didn't make use of the Uber. They had a scout briefly on point and got it to about 75%, but just didn't really push it. They were kind of used to just going in and smashing faces in massive team fights, and really they just failed. They're going to try and have a better attempt at reclaiming this second point though. They've got good positioning up, and there's a scout right on the flank. He's going to take down a soldier. That's going to be the first frag of this fight. They're just getting completely forced back here, and Citroën are gonna be able to pick it up. That scout overextending isn't gonna be able to get anything though. And Ubers are fairly equal, but I imagine Citroën will just push this straight through.
Oh, they are. They're going in on the left-hand side. Only Walkie a casualty, but the spawners are gonna come in. Look at the double soldier aggression again, and they're just crushing everybody on the red team here. Oh, but that
the one
pipe at the end saves it. Absolutely saves it there, Razor.
Oh no no! 60 HP, 30, he's dead.
BB! He goes huge! Saving that round for his team, absolutely there. He's just sat on the point, knows that somebody's going to come in. Walkie's coming in!
No!
Oh, the two shot. Nobody else is going to be able to get on the point in time! There we go, made that 3-0. The hero play from the BB. Not enough to... how many frags did he get there at the end? Three? And then couldn't take the fourth against Walkie? The rest of his team just getting put on his back.
Man, this is the third round was a lot more even, but in the end it was just, it just seemed to be coming out on top in all of these fights, Citro.
There are items on the line, killstreak items. This is serious business right now, guys. Citroën has stepped into kitchen now. He's coming out, he's gonna bomb forward into the combo. He's trying to get onto Tom, gets that med pick, but that's the only pick so far in this mid for either team. Now it's all going in favor of our blue team, Citroën's Mike Care package. They're crushing another mid fight here, but I do still see the glimmer of hope from Donata. They've managed to keep a couple of players alive here, but on life support right now.
3 HP.
Come on, B-roll! Ah! Man down.
That mid was started so much better. They took the height, and the Citroën weren't able to contest them, and it was almost like they were shouting and mumbling, "We did it, boys! We got control!" But then they just didn't do anything with it, and Citroën just walked along the floor across the point and just destroyed the rest of their team while the soldiers up top just sort of looked around aimlessly.
Let's see if the BV can have a fantastic defense again. He's going to be switching over the spawn in order to get the bomb out, but he's in the middle of an Uber charge. Walkie again is going to get onto him, and Citroën, the eponymous Citroën, is going to be sat on top of that house, just making sure that everything is contained there. And Citroën's Mike Care package taking a 4-0 lead after only 10 minutes. We need our boys from Donata to put more of a fight than this, Admirable.
Yeah, this stage of the tournament is best of one as well, so this is match point right now, guys. And Citroën's Mike Care package are looking to make another slam dunk on mid here. Demo men contesting each other right now. It's Ryder versus Beyond, but Ray is going to rush forward here. The Red Scar gets the demo pick. Huge plays. He's just set it up for his team here. But here comes the aggression now. FD's jumping behind. He doesn't go directly into the combo. Tries to distract Citroën as well. Goes into the Saw Room there, and wow, Donata don't know where to look, but somehow they still have three players alive here. They're trying to make it work, but a huge arrow from Costin gonna send Snurlax packing, and now it's all on Avery. His rockets are wild, he's trying to connect the feed here. One rocket will kill him, but he just can't land it. And wow, feed denies his medic the second pick of middle there, but solid play coming out from Citroën's Mike Care package, I think.
We look lost at the start of that, really. The scout, I can't remember who it was, but the scout player rushing across completely took out the demo man, and their only option really was what they took, and it was to bomb their two soldiers in, and they made it work. They got the medic picked down, but they, as a cost of that, they lost, like, obviously their two soldiers, so you expected it just to be sort of a stalemate coming out of that, and they'd managed to save the Uber push onto last, but they actually ended up winning just by that pure raw deathmatch ability at the end, and they've kept it onto second enough to keep up the pressure and then not allow Donata out to contest the second point. They're going to be forced back to last, but now it's a question of whether Costin will push in time with this Uber before Citramine's might care package get theirs.
And they are going underneath with the double soldier, Uber, FD, and Citramine leading it forward. Nice shot onto Tom there, a direct, and Avery is going to get taken down. The red team all kind of bunched him on this left-hand side. Donato need to pull something together. This defense, the BV juggled in the air. There's going to be no clutch defense from him. And Raider gets the pike on
Custin.
Everybody.
Look at Custin.
No!
Taunting on the point. Not like this.
Not like this.
And Axton seals the deal for his team there. Citramine's might care package. And Donato, bada bing, bada boom, out of the tournament. Good night, Donato.
Oh, that was the fastest.
Brutal.
First round rip I've ever seen.
That was a big gamble there from Costin. Like, he just went and hid around behind that oil tank whilst his team fought in the middle. But clearly he knew what was going to happen. He is the mastermind. But Sideshow. Like, we're still in round one here. There could be a chance of us jumping into another game. What do you think?
Yeah, I think we absolutely should. I mean, this because all the games start at slightly different times, this one's only been going for about 10 minutes now. The next game, I mean, I'm just diving into the Source TV at the moment. It is still 0-0 as well. And the actual game itself has only been live for a minute and 15 seconds. So I think that's... as a blinder, we'll jump into that one. It is round one, match eight, between Peraspeda ad Astro and the Coco Smugglers. So the exotic team names coming out here in TF2 Pickups Open Rumble. But as I said, 0-0 the score at the moment. You guys all have the STV, so as soon as you're in, give me a shout. But I'm seeing some off-class defense here from Peraspeda ad Astra, and they're making it work.
I typed it into Google Translate, and the translation isn't actually helping at all.
Ah, well, who knows? Who knows? They do have some players that I've never heard of, actually. I do actually think I recognize one or two of these names. It does seem to be a bit back and forth here between the two teams. Niven as well is Hungarian, if I'm not mistaken, from the Coco Smugglers, and SSIRD. Why? I think he's Hungarian as well. But let's see the Brazilian Wonder Team making their way forwards through the kitchen area here. They might be able to catch out the Hungarian medic from the what the hell are they called? The Coco Smugglers. But they haven't quite found him, and he's out with 67%. Golovin Oglio is chasing him in upper lobby though, and he's trying to get onto him. Oh, he's giving him the jukes. I don't know whether this soldier's going to be able to find his prey. But he's pushed the blue medic here all the way back to spawn, and they managed to secure a lot of ground for it.
Still had a little attempt at sniper actually going on in the middle there as well, but wow. Pera Aspera and Astra are, man, they're putting pedal to the metal here. They are moving forward, having taken middle. They're now on CP4, and it doesn't even look like the Coco Smugglers want to contest. BizBaz, their demo man's going to get caught in lobby there by Crow, and we're going to see the red wave continue. They're rushing through from the left-hand side here, but they're not overcommitting to the point. You know, fairly decent positional play here. They forced out the Uber charge, now they're going to back out and wait for their own charge. They've actually got man advantage. The health is terrible right now for the Coco Smugglers, and I think this could be a slam dunk here for Aspera ad Astra.
We need to find a way of contracting their name. We'll just call them the Vauxhall Astras, and we can roll forward with that. They have taken the first round, though, after a tense 4-minute battle. This game looks a little closer than the previous one that we were having a look at. It is best of one, as it was in the other match on CP Snakewater. So we'll see who comes out on top. Let's have Ali take us through the second mid fight as well. Who are you watching?
Ali's just watching the team names from Peraspera ad Astra. There's a guy called Golovonoji, which I'm just hoping he doesn't do anything exciting, because otherwise I'm going to have to try and shout his name awkwardly. It's actually going to be the soldiers from the Coco Smugglers who try to take the initiative. They're going to get spammed back, but Niven is going to counter jump. It's quite a much more passive mid than we saw in the other game there. The scouts moving forward, but they're just getting blasted back. There's really good zone control here by either team, not letting the other ones get the advantage. And this is just going to be played out slower and slower. It's actually the Coco Smugglers who do start moving across point. The soldier spam, really nice play from Niven, actually. He completely did just a lot of good work in denying any ground that the Vauxhall Astras could have gained from that situation. They're just going to be forced to set up on second, but neither team with a disadvantage. So compared to the last game where we just sort of push us to last off every mid, we're actually going to see a stalemate, boys.
This seems like a much closer matchup there. And Trox, who is definitely like a a former Div 1, Div 2 journeyman from Russia, was taking a lot of damage and he was just forced to back out. He didn't even contest it, but now he's actually going to get the first frag of this engagement. But whoa, Crow's in on Bizbaz again, so two picks there and no demo man up right now for the Cocoa Smugglers. They're in trouble. They've been forced to use their Ubercharge. They're hemorrhaging players. Another scout going down. Niven is now holding forward all alone. He doesn't realize his retreat's been cut off though. And it's just absolute pandemonium here on this midpoint, but somehow these three players managed to escape. And they do have those favorable spawns being in control of middle, but it looks like they don't want to contest anymore. FUBU's going to go down, and that'll be the full stop at the end of that fight.
That was beautiful from the Italian team scouts. It was like Reiko and Reds, they just rushed in from the side onto point and completely split up the Cocoa Smugglers team. They didn't actually do a hell of a lot of damage, but they just made space. And making space is what it's all about.
They're going to be trying to push forward with the slight uber advantage that they have at the moment. The frags on the flank though, as Crow takes two frags and Nedgemans takes another one. There's a battle with the Devilman and a scout around in this cheese area as well. Whoever gets the better end of this is going to be doing fairly well. The Soldier of Golo, oh my word, there, Dveki just annihilating that demo and gets the second frag as well. Big plays from the scout from Cocoa Smugglers, and he's potentially saved his team there in a sticky situation by just overextending a little bit and dragging those two players out, stopping them pushing into last. He's bought his team so much time to set up that defense, and they're going to be running a sniper and a pyro as well as they attempt to push out into upper lobby.
Bizbaz is setting up a devious sticky trap on lower there. Doesn't look like anyone is planning to take that route though just yet. They're trying to contest here, just spamming each other, you know, jostling for position here around the lobby, but neither team has Ubercharge, so like, I'm loving this aggressive play coming out. Niven, he's trying to be the driving force here for Cocoa Smugglers, but he just can't seem to find his way in. But whoa, Bolo with the big headshot there onto unpronounceable scout name guy, and this could be the beginning of the action.
Yeah, it was a really nice shot from Unpronounceable Sniper as the Uber does come through. They've actually Ubered behind them here, Herr Aspir, I'm just going to call them the Italians. And they do look like they're having the better end of this conversation. There's really low players from their team though, and they're not going to be able to get much from this. The Sniper isn't going to be able to hold much ground though, and the combo just really needs to heal up in order to take this fight. They've got spawners coming in 1 second, but there's still six people up from the Italian team here, and they're just going to launch at some point. The demo is up, but he's not going to be able to do anything in time. 2-0 boys, close game, but 2-0.
2-0 to the Vauxhall Astras, and as we approach our third mid, it's really on the Cocoa Smugglers to smuggle more than cocoa out of this mid if they wanna get a little bit better. They need to be smuggling a lot of frags out of the situation as well. So Bish Bash looking
Bosch
to apply some Bosch onto the enemy team. I'm watching this Devilman. Trox is coming in. He's got his number though. He's trying to get as much damage out. Propelled into the air though and destroyed with hit scan. He's made a lot of room, and the rest of his team have done so much damage. Everyone there in the red from the Cocoa Smugglers. But Vecchi really wants this frag on the medic of Bugsa, but he's not going to find it. They need to go balls deep here and try and take down Bugsa though.
I so nearly pulled that back. They were just getting completely destroyed at first. They committed a lot of people to actually kill the medic, and although they didn't get him straight away, it wasn't capitalized on by Perispera. They didn't just think, oh, okay, they've committed all these people, we can win the DM. But they didn't win the DM, and the medic did go down, but like no cost at all. Like, if you commit a ton of people on middle, like, you've got to lose positioning, and the other team has to capitalize on it, and they didn't at all. So it's good work to exploit the fact that the other team wouldn't capitalize on it, but really it's a position to improve for Cocoa Smugglers rather than Perispera making the brilliant plays.
I feel like right at the end of that mid fight as well, they probably could have just gone for it. It was like three combat classes against two and a medic, but Bizbaz was making the bite play, ran back to set up sticky traps on two and beat his team out. But here comes the uber push from the right hand side of that roller door, and they've managed to yield two frags so far. But the heavy weapons guy of Dvuki is soaking up all that damage. It's now all on Bizbaz and FUBU to try and go 1v4, but no, it's not gonna happen, and that will be the third round here. And it's all one-way traffic here for the Vauxhall Astras.
They need to start pulling something back. Potentially, their problem on the last mid was that Trox made so much room for the rest of the team, they weren't able to actually stop him before he was already in amongst them, like a cat among the pigeons.
And so I'll be looking for one of the scouts here from Coco Smugglers to take more of an aggressive position on the high ground and deny either Trox or Golovanogliov. And Trox is going to be coming forward again. Tons of damage out once again, and everybody from the Coco Smugglers so much further back, and Golovanogliov comes in and grabs those frags onto Fubu and Bish Bash Bosh. So it's disastrous here for the other team. They do seem to have switched around their classes as well. Serdi now on Soldier, and Fubu on Medic, so they weren't feeling the previous lineup, but that one worked out, in fact, even worse.
I wouldn't call it even worse. Coco Smugglers did actually manage to take down the Medic, so it's not going to be a direct advantage.
And I believe he's switched over to the Critskrieg as well. The Vauxhall Astra is now running in the crits as the Bugzer switches over and makes his way forwards. They are going to have about a 10-15% advantage by the time these Ubers are up. Maybe a little bit more than that if they build heavily, which it looks like they are with Crow. Let's see how they opt to use this. Trox has just found two frags. They should just go now, to be honest. They'll have that Uber charge up in 10 seconds and they'll just be able to use it in the midst of a fight.
Yeah, they should have definitely had another one, but it was a really nice win for Longyearneck underneath to win that scout 1v1, and he's just come up on the side, and they're all dealing massive damage, but there's a scout on the point, and there's no way they can get back to him in time. The numbers were pretty even there towards the end, but it was just like sneaking in from the right-hand side when the fight was mainly on the left. That was pretty close, but once again, it's just outplayed.
The demo man managed to just walk up and flank the Medic until they take him out of the game. And then everyone thought the fight was going well, they ran away from the point, but it's points that win prizes here in the TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble number one. We're onto this.
Raffles
potentially
also win
final
prizes
medal
at Marvel. You don't need points, you just need raffles.
Oh, Trox is in doing huge work here. And Fubu the Medic is going to go down as Golo comes in and tag teams with Trox there for huge damage. Now it's Golo versus Bolo, but Golo's going to come out on top. It's all on Serdi. He's trying to do his best here. It's desperation right now for Coco Smugglers, but I think they've been busted, man. Customs and Excise are in here in full effect. This is the end for them, for sure.
And the Coco Smugglers will smuggle no more. Coco is highly valued as a commodity, and there is no way that the Vauxhall Astras are going to let them smuggle it out in their car. So Bugsy and the crew are going to be moving forward. He's now switched over to the normal Medic, but look at the sticky trap. Is he going to walk into it?
Oh, Escher.
Bish Bash, he's just looking at it.
Beautiful by Golo.
Bugsy is absolutely playing with fire here. The stickies are blown. Bish Bash didn't have the patience.
The Bosh.
The Bosh either. Bugs that manages to hold onto his Uber. They should be able to use it as well. They are 6v4. Bish Bash has been caught in the lobby. And as they push in on the left hand side, Bolon Yerikakov is not going to be able to get any damage out with the sniper rifle either onto Uber targets. Should switch class. A desperate defense here, admirable.
Oh, they are not in love with the Coco.
Oh, he's still alive. He dreams alive.
He's got the charge.
Bugs is trying to juke, but 30 health is not going to be enough. But now Golo is jumping in. Find time here for nothing. It's all on Ihor now. Can he go 1v4? He is the demo man, the most OP class in the game. But no, he's gonna run. He's gonna live to fight another day from Cheese. Here comes Devki. He's coming in below. He's blindsiding Ihor potentially a bit. He's gonna give his game away though. He's starting to cap the point here. The information is available, but Ihor is determined to hold Cheese. Meanwhile, Nejmas and Crow have arrived. Trox is in as well. They're just throwing bodies here into the blue meat grinder, and this could be the sea change right now, guys. Still 16 minutes left on the clock.
Here we go, three players down here from the four players down. Only Bugzer and Ihor alive, and Ihor's been caught out in a bad position. This is where they believe in themselves and gather some momentum. They're going to push forward here. They still have a pyro, actually, as far as I can see. Is that right? Yeah, they're pushing out with a pyro. That's the magical point here, Ali. The overpowered pyro class has made them, has swapped the momentum, swung it in their favor. And they're going to try and roll this one forwards and make it 4-1. There's still 15 and a half minutes remaining. They can do it.
The things you realise when you're 4-0 down is that you've got a completely meta-breaking strat, which is taking that pyro on to last. And let's see if it works for them. Trox is going to come in behind. That pyro could really pay dividends here. If they just push into lobby, they'll take out that soldier as well. But there's no frags exchanged yet so far. There's that soldier behind them. That's going to cause something.
A demo.
And a demo caught out too. The medic will... full pop the Zuba. They've got one frag at anything more. They really should be able to push forward and get something here, but they're just not. And the counter pop is going to come out. Medic's surely going to go down. He's on 15 HP, trying to jump away. He's going to go down. Solid picking up the health pack on the point. They're just in a commanding position right now. The rest of the Coco Smuggler just scattered all around them. Niven's going to win a 1v1, though. He's going to get taken down by the arrow. It's just Dev. He alive behind at the moment.
And the pyro of Surrey, never forget about the pyro threat. He's coming in. Can he? He gets a replacement. Cannot connect with Trox. It's all on Surrey now. He managed to get the cap there. Huge plays. His team are going to get forward spawn as well. There's three up right now. Bizbas, Niven, and Bolo are ready to contest, or at least defend middle here. But they are about to face six fully buffed players. Coming in from both the lower, and we've got Golo coming in from the flank as well. He's going to jump in from the little balcony. He's got the high ground already. Who's going to contest him? Nobody, it seems. Bolo runs in and takes a 1-on-1 with Crow and comes out on top, but it's actually looking good right now for the Coco Smugglers.
Yeah, pushing them back completely, and this soldier's like, just both of them quite weak and having to get healed up. There's a scout flank coming in. It's another 1v1 between Name and Polon Girek that's going to end in stalemate this time. Previously, we've just seen either team go ham, but it's the Uber that's going to come out and completely smash Bizbash and VQ. And he's going to, Ali's going to be thinking about these names a lot more before he shouts them in the future, because they're really quite hard to say. It's just Surdy now coming in with three S's, irrationally so. And yeah, it was so looking so good for Coco's Mothers. Now they're getting pushed back. The medic needs to be running though. He's got spawners, but he's running underneath. I'm not sure even if the spawners will keep him alive though, if a proper aggression comes through. But no, he is going to be safe getting out the last. But the demo man, not sure about Bizbash.
Oh, he's juggled him up in the air. Misses the air shot there onto Golovo. Golovonig. No. I'm going to pronounce it properly.
Let's call him Golo.
Golovonogai. Golovonogi. Something like that. Potentially something like that. I've forgotten what I was even saying about him. Something about missing an air shot or something. But they are going to be pushing into a triple off-class defense here. Surdy watching on the pyro, defending his sniper brethren as the heavy sets up on the point as well. This is an interesting strategy going for the pyro defense, Admirable. Do you like it?
I love it. Surdy the 30 with the big plays here. He's thinking outside the box. He's going to let them through the door. He's going to keep them in. He doesn't want to keep them out. He wants to keep them in. Welcome to my world of pain, says Surdy. He's going to punish this medic. He's set on fire. God. It's sick torture. He's dead. Rest in peace.
He did. He stopped the medic getting out there after a bad Ubercharge. It's next level stuff. And it's only Crow and Golovoni really in a position to do anything.
Oh my god. Oh, Nijmas. You didn't see him. He could have gone for last. But instead, he couldn't have gone for last. He's a heavy there. But it is going to be Golovonogi. Just the last player still alive underneath. He's going to peek out. Really think twice about that before he goes in. But there's a scout on second now, so he is going to end up going down. I reckon they can definitely take this. The spawners aren't going to be there in time. Ihor has already set up sticks in Sorum, trying to look for that soldier to jump into window. And yeah, this has become a lot more even. It's quite sad that it has to happen at 4-0.
Yeah, but they can still bring it back here. There's 12 minutes, so that's 3 minutes around. It's all the time in the world, but not if Ihor keeps getting those lovely little picks like that in the window with a classic Bite sticky trap. Did Bite ever play Snakewater as Demoman? I don't think he actually ever did, but Nijmans as well takes a pipe to the face, but he's not actually going to find the return frag. Both of these Ubers up, but the pressure is on the Coco Smugglers to start going fairly quickly. They need to get the banana boat going.
What do you mean, did Bite ever play Snake War? That was like 2011 when Snake War came in.
I don't think he ever did.
What?
As Demoman, I think he played it as Medic.
As Medic, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Definitely. Oh, anyway, action continues here, and the counter pop is coming in from Coco Smugglers. Surdy was jumping forward there, looking for a little support from his team. They could have crushed it, but they decided to show mercy to the Vauxhall Astras. They have a lot of respect for the automotive powerhouse. But, oh, Bolo was coming from behind now. Nice coordination here, but the deathmatch is far superior, it seems, from Per Aspera and
medic?
Astra.
Medic went down to 20 HP there, but they just couldn't finish him off. They gave all their players up. It's going to be a wipe. Demoman spawning. Going to need to pull off some Ihor-style sticky traps, as Ihor is actually going to be the one to jump forward. He picks the wrong spawn door, though. As Bishbash spawns on the left-hand side, the scout's going to come in from under the medic and the soldier. They do have the spawners in time with that lucky pyro. And the scout's getting laid, but the pyro's down to 1 HP. He's going to get picked off, but they're not making much use of the space right now. It's best to back off and just stay with their Uber advantage. And that's what they're actually doing. So, living to fight another day, and yeah, definitely the right choice to back up here.
Yeah, they're going to be able to get all the way back to last, but it's going to be a lot of pressure for them. There's 10 minutes left. They need to start turning things around now if they want to get back into the game. And the Vauxhall Astros are really going to want to close things out. There's an air shot from Trunks onto Surdy. That's not going to be a great way to start things off. Powering forward with the Uber as well here. It gets a lot of damage onto Bish Bash. Fubu as well, only on 4 health. Not going to be dishing out heals to the rest of his team. That Heavy doesn't even have a glove. And the double stack on the point. They're just annihilating that Heavy. 5-0 there sweet. To the Vauxhall Astros.
They're sweet.
And they managed to grab that one and take themselves into round two, which is a best of one on CP Sunshine. So we're going to see some of these open teams eliminated. Good night. And 8 of them move forwards to battle it out on Sunshine and then go forwards into the quarterfinals or whatever that would be. Is that the semifinals after that? I have no idea how
that works. Well, so far we've had 8 teams eliminated. Yeah, so far. So all of our round 2 teams have been decided. 50 Blessings versus Rebels, Whatever Bro versus Citramate's team that we saw earlier, Millennium LEGE something, I'm guessing that's Legends, versus Monkey Gamers, and then Chaotic Pups versus our victorious Astras right here. Gonna have to pick which game of those we want to look at.
Yeah, let's take a look at round 2, match 1, 50 Blessings versus the Rebels. 50 Blessings got a bye in the first round, and the Rebels storming through in their match, but I see some names that I potentially recognise. I see Timon there on the 50 Blessings side, and the Rebels spotting some great names like Commander Thundercock. So we'll have to make sure that we spectate him and see how that game flows. I'm going to be launching myself into that very shortly just to see how these two teams stack up against each other. But, I mean, fantastic, fantastic names.
You mean... I think, well, it'd be better if we'd said fantastic, fantastic games, but they've all been pretty one-sided so far. But yeah, I can't wait to see you launch yourself into Commander Thundercock.
Yeah, I do enjoy the fact that these players all seem to have fairly pronounceable names too. Although I did enjoy the tongue twister that was Pera, Aspera, and Astra versus Coco Smugglers, Golo and Bolo. Never forget. Let's go though, it's round 2 baby, the competition is heating up as we progress through the stages of the single elimination bracket. We're going to be getting closer and closer games. The first two were 5-0s, but they were definitely different kind of 5-0s. There was much more of a fight coming out in that last game, but the team play from the Vauxhall Astros, the focus fire was just far superior to their opponents. I'm jumping into STV now as well, Sideshow. Are you there?
No, not quite.
I'm here already. We're seeing... 3 players joined so far, so you got time. You got time.
We got time. We got time. We got time to plug scrap.tf/TFTV for the raffles that are going on courtesy of Jill. And head on over to scrap.tf if, like me, you have a ton of items and no way of turning them into anything useful. So that's not very useful. Also, gonna plug the blog.tf2pickup.net. That's tf2pickup, the main sponsor of this tournament. They have a blog about them going global and taking over North America as well. So if you guys are from North America, which would be very early in the morning, if you want to have tf2pickup.net over there, have a read of their blog, see what they're up to.
Yeah, just had a fucking total tf2 flashback there. Do you remember whenever Vanilla TV made a blog about how they were going to take over the world?
Yep.
I don't even remember that. What happened there at Marvel? Teachers or history teacher?
I can't remember what the whole situation was, but you know, it was maybe a low point in activity for Vanilla TV, and then they came out and said how they were going to... they started a French-speaking channel, and they had like Ponyon and whoever, and then they were like, what next? The world? And they had like, you know, the Dad's Army map of them spreading out from Europe to North America. It didn't happen. Sorry, mate.
See, the thing is, for a casting organization, how do you really branch out from English to North American? I mean, it's...
totally different languages, mate.
Totally different, totally different. But for TF2Pickup.net, it does open up some pug systems in America. At the moment, really all they have is the TF2 PugMe Captain System, or TF2 Center. And neither of them quite as good, in my opinion, as TF2Pickup.net. Some very... hard-working individuals making sure that pug system works incredibly well. So check that out, blog.tf2pickup.net, and also have a look at the raffles in the stream as well. These guys are filtering onto the server here.
And I can actually see Commander Thundercock repping the Scout class. For some reason, I thought he would be a soldier. I feel like that's much more of a soldier name.
It's about a commanding presence. I mean, we can give a little insight into his backstory, in that when he joined the server, his name wasn't Commander Thundercock, he changed it from Phallic Double Entendre. So it's a man of an immense arsenal of great names. The first log when I joined the server was Phallic Double Entendre has joined the server, he's changed his name to Commander Thundercock, and is now ready.
I think there's some truth to what you're saying though, Sideshow. You know, there's something very phallic about the rocket launcher, especially the Bulbous original. It's like, oof, you know what you're working with there, but this guy's going to be playing Scout, so I'm prepared to try and make that leap. There's a little bit of, you know, he's breaking my immersion here, but I still want to believe in Commander Thundercock. Let's do a little bit of a roster rundown since we have some time here. And playing in blue will be the Rebels. On Demoman, we're going to have Embrace. We have Yeeps on Medic, early playing Scout. And we're going to have Paprika playing as... let me see, actually, which guy?
Soldier.
Is he going to be the Roamer or the Pocket? Oh, yeah. Bohawk has the Gunboat, so he's going to be the Roamer, I'm guessing. And Paprika should be the Pocket. Ali, you want to tell me about 50 Blessings? I can hear it.
Oh, man. I would love to tell you about 50 Blessings right now. They're all actually on the server, whereas there's only five from Rebels.
Yeah, we're missing Commander Thundercock. That's who we're missing.
Well, we've not gone right. I see why you chose to try and explain Rebels team. Sadly, he let you down there. But on the 50 Blessings team, we are going to see Shandos on Medic, Timo Rex on Demo. Not sure which of the soldiers is roaming or pocket. You can find out, that'd be sick. But it's gonna be Toki and Goz on soldiers and Erhany and Omai. Can you pronounce that scout name? I thought you said this one would be easier.
Probably not.
Yeah, Erhany and Mitoki, yeah.
It begins AE. How can you put an M in there?
AE? Oh, which one am I looking at? Oh,
a cough.
You see, it's quite difficult.
A cough. He's cough. A soldier, it's, okay.
It's a phonetic spelling of a cough. Okay, it's cool. Onomatopoeia itself. Goz is going to be the roaming soldier for that team, and Mitoki is going to be their pocket. The pocket's thankfully running the shotgun, unlike all these high-level teams where you can't tell who's who just based on their loadout anymore.
What unlocks are we rocking in this tournament, by the way? Because there's been the whole sort of new wave and pickups of people running this sort of huntsman trash.
Oh yeah, that's Permzilla has released the new official ETF2L whitelist, isn't that right, Saito?
Absolutely, yeah, that's correct. If you want to check out the new official, completely endorsed by Permzilla ETF2L whitelist, it's whitelist.tf/4427, I think was the most recent one that he said he absolutely does not endorse in any way, shape, or form. Permzilla, who is the head admin of ETF2L, along with Sonny Black and Ash. Is Ash still head admin? Who knows? Anyway, they are fiddling around with the whitelist, trying to make it a bit more open before matchmaking hits. And so TF2Pickup.net over the last 2 days, just yesterday and today, have been trying out some different whitelists. There's nothing official yet, but ETF2L thinking about opening it up a little bit more, which is very nice. Oh, Whitehouse just messaged me saying it's whitelist.tf/4432, and there is now an ETF2L thread about it, so it may actually be official. I thought it wasn't.
What do you think about that sort of high-level motivation that we want to make the whitelist closer to matchmaking when we really don't know what matchmaking is going to be like, and we haven't really... kowtowed to Valve too much over the last 7 or 8 years. Why all of a sudden are we bending over backwards to bring in all these unlocks that we'd turned our back on?
I think it boils down to two facts. Like, one, we know that matchmaking is going to hit, and fairly soon, within probably
soon,
6 months.
Valve time.
Yeah, soon Valve time, but I'd say definitely within the next 6 months we'll be hearing something about matchmaking. It'll probably be released
we'll
by then.
We'll be hearing something.
Yeah,
we'll
3 months ago it's going to be 3 months. Someone saw something, or they worked out that the Gunmetal campaign was going to be ending at the end of September. Matchmaking
maybe
could be announced then.
Well, it may well be, but I think we really have to be making steps towards uniting our lovely 6v6 concept with theirs as well. And one of the things that we can almost guarantee is that they are going to be allowing most, if not all, of the weapons. So it makes sense to open up the whitelist.
But these weapons aren't balanced, Sideshow.
They aren't. They're not yet admirable. That's the point. They want to allow them in matchmaking so that they have data to balance them off. So for the first time ever, the competitive side of TF2 will be what all the weapons are balanced for, which is fantastic for us. But it means that for the beginning of it, we're going to be playing with some very unbalanced shit.
I'm playing devil's advocate here, guys. I am the guy who was nagging from Zilla yesterday to add the Gunslinger and the Phlogistonator to 6v6.
There's nothing wrong with either of those weapons, yeah, honestly. Like, the Gunslinger got nerfed pretty hard in the Gunmetal update and now spawns with 50 health, and you can just tap that with
even
anything.
Even a scout can kill that.
Yeah,
one
exactly.
Shot.
I don't think it's as much of a problem as people make out. People make out that it's this devil weapon that should never be allowed, but I think it's perfectly fine.
And
I think people will be happy with any sort of weapon that just involves like a skill ceiling rather than straight overpoweredness. Like, I think we can't expect the game like not to change in terms of the fact that we could see like a finals match in 2 years where nobody is running any of the stock weapons kind of situation. But
okay, I can give you a rundown of the Permzilla has made it official today, actually, at 10:30 okay. a.m. today, that they're going to be running a test whitelist. So it's not the official one for season 22, but is their official test whitelist. So these are the things that you can give feedback on. So for scouts, they've allowed the backscatter and the baby faces blaster. Now, the baby faces blaster was like this insanely overpowered weapon about 2 months ago, and then the Gunmetal update, they nerfed it really hard, and so I don't think that's a problem. For the soldier, the rocket jumper, battalion's backup, mantreds, and market gardener. I am going to love playing with the market gardener and mantreds. You will
what
not see
the bonk?
Me. No, the bonk actually got removed. They were thinking of adding the bonk, but it's
cost.
It's actually incredibly. it's insane.
It's really fucking annoying.
Yeah, it's dreadful for any kind of competitive environment to give you like to give your scout like a mini Uber, but he can't shoot. It's really strange. It can allow you to do a whole load of crazy things. For Demoman, the lock and load, the target charge, the Ullapool caber, and the sticky jumper. The Ullapool caber is going to be allowed along with the target charge and the lock and load.
Did you
load.
Say the market gardener as well?
Yeah, these are some class A hilarious unlocks. Yeah, these are the kind of unlocks that people love to use in pubs just to troll about, so it's going to be fantastic if we ever see them used in an actual game.
The cave
is going to
be
living it,
right? From when you can one-shot medics.
Yeah, I think it still does a lot of damage though, but it doesn't one-shot a medic anymore.
Okay.
It probably would, like, for a suicide bomb on Viaduct or something, you know, if somebody's put a little bit of damage on them, you can bomb in with your stickies and then attempt to smack them in the face.
The caber got heavy usage in Highlander, like, as a legitimate weapon.
Yeah.
I've faced it many times, sometimes less favorably than others, but
especially combined with the sticky jumper. Can you imagine that on Viaduct? Yeah. I mean, you just bomb it.
Is that
going to
be? Is that allowed? The sticky jumper?
Yeah.
Mm. That's going to be a little weird.
And sticky jumper,
the rocket
and the
jumper
and
as well.
No, not. Oh yes, the rocket jumper as well.
So like, you can have these soldiers just jumping around or demo men. Yeah, I suppose at the high level, it's not going to be that much of a impactful. But I don't know the. The amount of scope for trolling with the no damage jumping weapons is, I don't know. I don't care. I'm not going to be playing this season. I look forward to this mayhem.
For the heavy, the holiday punch, and the killing gloves of boxing. So
To see the Fist of Steel, actually. I think that is actually a useful unlock. Like, you
but
can
the
use
Fist
it...
of Steel, you can just use to tank so much more damage than you would otherwise.
Exactly.
Why is that a good thing?
Because it's a different use. You can even use it to push last, not just hold last. You know, you can use it as bait.
Yeah, of course you could, but it just makes an already incredibly tanky character into an incredibly tanky character.
How often do you see a heavy actually being effective at the top level of play? They're usually just focused down instantly. At least if you have the Fists of Steel, you force them into a choice. Like, they can still run in and melee you with their fucking Boston Bashers or whatever. But
that's just never going to happen, though.
If you had Ubered your scouts in to kill a heavy, you know, I'm theory crafting here, Saito. I just want to see unlocks that are actually going to have a real impact, you know? That's why I said, you know, gunslinger, quick fix.
Well, unfortunately for the engineer, no gunslinger, but the Eureka effect, which honestly, I don't even know what it does. I know what it looks like because I've had to delete lots of them from my backpack, but I have no idea what it does.
It teleports you back to spawn. Actually, it's been updated in the Gunmetal update. I don't know. I haven't played enough with it, but the general gist of it was that it teleported you back to spawn, you know, so you could still have your buildings run back to spawn and get ammo, etc. But, honestly, can't speak with any great confidence about that one. This game has taken a while to begin. Maybe we should have jumped to another game sideshow. You know, we're going to be in a strange limbo situation here. I know other games are happening this round.
They're requesting to add someone else to like join the server, and they say Red Team have said that person's coming.
So oh, Delusive!
We should be good. We should be good. Delusive, Wonder Admin.
I'm throwing up my D's in STV chat. Delusive, he seems to be the figurehead of Gaming Grids, the developers of Razer Arena. He's been throwing all this money at TF2 over the last couple of months, sideshow. I think we need to, you know, salute this guy. Everyone,
absolutely.
This is spam some hearts in Twitch chat there for Delusive. And there is going to be back-to-back cups happening today. We've got this TF2 pickup.net open rumble number one, but then after that we're going to be jumping straight into the Gaming Grids TF2 Fragfest EU version. I think it's about the 12th one, and we're going to hopefully catch the semi-finals and finals, so we're going to have a variety of skill levels on display here today, Saito.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to jump from this open rumble where the top two teams at the final are probably going to be probably around a mid-level, really. Like, they're going to be the top of open, maybe mid. But then we're going to be launched straight from that into the top of the Frankfest where the big boys are playing. I don't think any teams are actually playing because the teams are in that strange limbo situation after I-55 where they are still sorting out their rosters and things. They're still all fighting over the top players to add into their potential rosters for next season and next LAN and things like that. So I think we're going to be seeing just a lot of high level mixes. We're potentially going to see like the first glimpses of some new teams maybe as well. If we have a look at some odd roster combinations, we might get a glimpse of that. But it'll certainly be interesting to jump from skill tier to skill tier.
I suppose something that's worth mentioning here, you guys did an incredible job of covering I-55, but imagine if you were, you know, your first time watching TF2 was I-55, now you've come in here and you're watching the Open Rumble. You know, this is like a totally different skill level here. This is like the entry level to competitive TF2. So if you were just curious about TF2, this is definitely a way you could get involved. But I just want to stress that this is not the highest level TF2, but we're shining a spotlight here. And I think Buttnose was the man behind this. What was his motivation, Sideshow?
I think his motivation was just to throw a bone to these lower level teams that don't often see the spotlight, don't often get the prize pools, you know? The motivation for these teams to play in tournaments is just to get better. They don't normally see themselves any further than the semifinals or something, quarterfinals even for some of these teams. It might just be the round of 64 or whatever. But those teams that do sign up for those big tournaments where all the Prem teams are in, they get a real benefit out of finishing in a certain position. You know, you can take real pride in the fact that you finished in the round of 16 or something like that when there were so many good teams in there. But he just wanted to throw a bone out to them and say, guys, there are things for you as well at the lower levels. We have prizes for you, we have casts for you, and you can get involved in TF2 no matter what your skill level. You don't have to be a god at the game.
And by cast for you, we mean if your name is slightly non-English, we're going to have immense trouble shouting it, but we'll do our best.
I think we should request that feature, actually, from Razer Arena, some sort of pronunciation guide for usernames.
You have to put a pronunciation, like, in terms of, like, short like three-letter sounds. Like
Google Translate integration, yeah. You know, you click the little speaker button and it says the name for you.
It's beautiful. Just submit a soundbite when you make your account.
We're still sitting here waiting for 50 Blessings and Rebels to get underway, but we do have 12 on the server, so wow, we could be getting underway very soon. One thing to remind everyone is that we are playing for prizes here. Sideshow mentioned it earlier, it is 6 professional killstreak kits, 6 specialized killstreak kits, and 6 killstreak kits, respectively, for first, second, and third, plus serve me. .tf server subscriptions. And if you are getting into competitive or you are a competitive player, having the sub level on serveme.tf is just incredible. If you become a donor or whatever, you can book multiple servers, you get access to a special pool of exclusive servers, so even at those busy times you can get yourself a server. And on top of that, you're supporting one of the coolest systems in TF2, single-handedly put together by Ari, and of course all the server donators, but like Ari is the hard carry in the competitive TF2 scene, doing so much work for us. But I just, you know what, man, we really take serveme.tf for granted. I just want to say, incredible service.
Yeah, that's crazy what you had to do before. You just had to, there's always a question of, does anyone on your friends list have a server we can borrow? Which is never a question that's asked anymore. Which has got to be a good thing.
Yeah, logs.tf recently reached 1 million games played on logs.tf.
Wow.
Which is insane. And Ari, the creator of serveme.tf, has over 20% of those uploads, so which is just an insane, insane amount. So what does that make it? Is that 200,000 uploads?
Just a handy 200,000. I suppose I should definitely big up Veethoofed as well. TF2pickup.net are the title sponsor of this tournament. Of course, he also created whitelist.tf, which has been getting heavy use in the last 24 hours with this all this Permzilla whitelist drama. But check out both of those sites. TF2pickup.net is definitely the place to go if you want to play some moderately high-level EU pickup action. You've also got tftcenter.com if you're getting into the game, but there are some higher skill requirements for tf2pickup.net, and I play there frequently, man. More so in the last couple of weeks than over the last 3 months, but I'm getting back into the game sideshow. Who knows? Maybe I'll start playing TF2 again and not cast. Is that actually your plan this season, sideshow? You're not going to cast. You're going to go for esports dreams.
I'm just going to give you the title of caster of the season on a golden plate. You know,
gonna have
I'll
to
just
get a bigger trophy cabinet.
Yeah, I'm I'm going to fiercely contest that title. There's no way you're having it back. I'm going to create my own dynasty. And there's it's going to be a new 50 years of Sideshow winning caster of the season. I'm not going to let anyone in.
Cubal TF2 is pleading with Twitch chat, don't go to TF2 pickup. I think he wants to maintain his skill level there or something. But we're just looking at the in-game chat right now, and Jeeps is requesting Rep Armed. Apparently he can't ready.
I think if they type !! Force ready in the chat, they will be able to ready up, but I need to...
They're requesting an admin role.
Lordy, lordy, right. Let me sort this game out, don't worry.
Ali, you've recently returned from a little bit of a hiatus yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Are you still in love with TF2 after all these years?
Man, I still got the fire. I wasn't sure, but I was watching F55, and being in that crowd is like the best thing ever. It looked really hype as well this year. And yeah, I'm really sad I missed it, so definitely got to get back enough to be there next year. Casting or playing or just being in the crowd would so have been worth it. Don't want to miss out on that again.
I still have yet to watch all the VODs, but we did get them up on YouTube there. You guys can head over to youtube.com/TeamFortressTV. We've got a full playlist there, like 20 VODs or something of all the I-55 games covered on Stream 1 and Stream 2. And they have been heralded as like the greatest games of TF2 played to date. Like apparently the most competitive offline tournament we've ever had, probably any tournament we've ever had yet. So definitely on my watch later list. Gonna get a casting masterclass from Sideshow and Gex as well. I gotta do my homework for this season, but looking into the future as well, we got some big TF2 events coming up. Deutschland, the first Highlander only LAN, is coming up. It's going to be happening in Germany, as the name might suggest. That will be next weekend. That's going to be casted on Blackout Gaming TV. You can see the event, and there'll probably be some articles coming out on teamforce.tv, also etftl.org. But, like, so impressed by those guys. Just doing it, man. You know, there's always this talk about organizing LANs. Is it possible? Can we organize one on our own? And the Highlander guys just says, okay, we're going to do it. They found a venue in Germany, like, with all these chalets and stuff. It's all self-encompassing there, and they've got the sponsors, they nailed their fundraiser, they met their stretch goals, their promotion has been incredible, so many show matches and stuff. Even if you're like, lol, HL, please tune in and support that event next weekend, because it's all TF2 and it's all esports, baby.
We esports now.
Then the weekend after that is going to be tip of the hat, you know, probably the biggest event in the TF2 calendar. Or the competitive TF2 calendar, And they support so many other facets of TF2 as well, like, you know, the Jump community. We'll have B-Ball there, Highlander, Sixes, show matches with any EU and NA, but we are going live here anyway, so do the promotion spiel later. Saito, are you back in the game with us?
No.
The game isn't going live. Everyone left. The game started and then everyone got timed out. The session has been cancelled.
There was an auto kick thing. Everyone was in 5, 4, just as you started saying, the game's going live.
I told them how to ready up and then Buttnose gave them a new server. So.
Fucking Buttnose!
We know who to blame, but yeah, they should be filtering onto new server. I think Buttnose just thought that would be the magic fix button. And so, as we see Commander Thundercock enter this new STV that I will give all of you, we really do need to stick around for this match as well, because the other games of round 2 have just now finished. We've been waffling on now for 30 minutes, and so all the other round 2 matches have finished. They need to wait for this game to finish though before they can really commence with round 3. So
I think that's not strictly true. Like, one side of the bracket might continue without us. We might end up in this weird situation where we're a round behind. We might have to follow 50 Blessings or Rebels all the way through to the final, potentially.
We could buckle in, guys. Yeah, we need to pick our favourites now. Who's going to win this one then? 50 Blessings or Rebels? Who are we going to be following all the way to the finals?
Rebels, Commander Thundercock is going to hard carry.
Hard carry.
See, you say that though, but Timon Rex on the other team, very strong main caller, has a lot of experience with tons and tons of low level teams, guiding them through the ranks and trying to make them a bit better. I believe in that guy. I think the 50 Blessings have got it.
Is he another sandbagger?
No, the way that this cup works is that if you played the majority of last season in Open, you are allowed to participate in the TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble. So as he did, he does have a little bit of experience in, I think, mid-high, but as he played the majority of last season with an Open team mentoring them, he is allowed to participate against Lord Commander Thundercock and attempt to knock him out of this tournament in a best of one on CP Sunshine.
Lord Commander Thundercock, is he from Game of Thrones? Watcher on the Wall, I'm Lord afraid, Commander Thundercock.
I'm afraid that reference flew over my head and made a whistling noise because
Season
I have not
spoilers.
Watched
you
any
not watch
of
Game
of Thrones. Not a single bit of it. I fear if I did, I'd lose all of my spare time.
Yeah, you know nothing, you've got Sancho. A lot of spare time now, Sancho.
You know nothing.
I want to mention as well, I'm not sure what I want to mention actually, I'm having another senior moment here.
It's alright, admirable, it's alright, we'll get through this. It's 2015, the day is Saturday. Sunday. Sunday, the day is Sunday.
I thought you were trying to troll him and then you sound panicked.
Hold on a minute. What was I talking about? Oh yeah. Tip of the Hat's coming up in 2 weeks' time then, after the weekend after Deutschland, but also have a preliminary date for the beginning of E2F2L. Week 1 will start right at the end of September, that last Sunday. I've been told, sorry Permzilla, the leak is real, but the week before that there will of course be Premiership qualifiers with so many new teams coming in. I'm sure that's going to be exciting, so pencil that one in your little stream diary. But yeah, that's all I got.
We've got life.
We ready, boys?
Oh, we are so ready, right? And after talking about him all this time, we cannot but watch Commander Thundercock as he comes through here. He is on that scout role, paired up with Early. We'll have to see what he's up to. He's going through that flank area, Paprika, with a fairly fast rollout as well. And they're going to attempt to lock down the enemy cafe. Oh, look at him, Commander Thundercock, making his way forwards. Still with a little bit of a buff. They're going to try and take down Hjulk Bank and push him back. They've got a decent position across the point, but they really haven't got very much damage out. And Motoki and Timon have taken down that early frag on the scout and done a lot of damage to the rest of the rebels here.
Thundercock picks up the first frag of the match for himself. He's going to be falling out on this flank, but it's all going to be in vain as the rest of his team can't live up to his high standards. He's coming back in though. He's going to try and take this one-on-one. He gets the meat shot straight on. Now he's on the medic. Thundercock is already carrying this game forward for his team. One more shot. Oh, Paprika's going to pick up the kill, but Thundercock made that play. They're just going to completely turn the tide of this mid back and pick up second point.
I feel like 50 Blessings really bottled it there in the middle. I know they were slightly outnumbered, but they had like forced Rebels out of the point. They could have just you know, manned up and capped the point together, but Timon Rex, he just bailed, left his scout medic there on middle. Actually, Shandos just back on the field now, having been slain previously, but he's at a huge uber disadvantage here. Timon's setting up the sticky trap there in lobby, but his stickies have been knocked off. The game is afoot. Paprika is now roaming through here for Rebels. He has worked his way into the lobby. Now he's going to blindside Timon. He's looking the wrong way, though. He's standing on the kit. Now he sees it. It's been called out. Demoman isolated. Surely going to get that frag, and he does. And this is huge. Not only do they have that Demoman advantage, but they now have uber advantage, too.
Yeah, they're gonna push through into last. Sorry, Sideshow, go.
No.
Fight.
Well, there is a fight happening on last right now. Motoki trying to see the other ones left alive, and they have to take out three players here. This is a big ask for Motoki. They are gonna get spawners though, just about now. The Demoman spawns because he got such an early death. Timon's gonna come out and try and defend him, but then he gets a few frags on the point.
Can't manage to land the last two onto early and the medic of Jeps. And so, a first round from the Rebels, but as you say, 50 Blessings were really in control of the mid-fight. They just let it slip through their fingers, and then that death from Timon sealed the deal.
That last point early, establishing himself as a worthy partner for Commander Thundercock into this middle. As you see, this next mid's going to go forward. Both demos playing fairly passively on each side of middle. Scout's just going to be ready to watch for their jumpers. Commander Thundercock once more the first one in. He's going to take a bit too much damage, though. Two scouts weak from either team. Both soldiers from Red Team are going to sit above that cafe area. And it's actually going to be a fight to take down Paprika. There's just 1v1 happening across the board. Toki is going to hit a nice air rocket there to take out. And the medic from 50 Blessings is going to be completely quite out of position now. We're just going to have the medic still alive from Rebels here, but they're outnumbered, and it's just going to be up to see if they can carry this momentum forward, Rebels. But early is going to be still on a lot of HP to defend his medic. They're not going to be able to win the point, but they should be able to push back with this uber.
Commander Thundercock and his Rebel army are getting pushed out of mid there, but they do keep Jeps alive, so he's going to have that uber. They're probably going to push back in. Somebody's going to go for the force. Looks like it's Khio Khio Bank on top above the cafe. Going to be thinking about forcing that, but the medic's still so far back. They do have tons and tons of time here. Chandos only on 40% just now. Building up that Kritzkrieg, actually. Kritzkrieg and Marble Alley. They are going to be in dire straits here if they manage to get the Uber out of Jeps.
Looks like it's going to be a cafe push here from our blue team Rebels. They're working their way forward, and they popped off early. This is playing right into the hands of Chandos, whose Kritzkrieg is nearing completion. As the uber fades, they're all just bunching up on choke here. Timon wants the crits, but oh no, only 96% for Chandos. He's left his Demoman high and dry. Actually, he's going to survive.
Here we go. They're all on the point. Gets one, two. Can they get any more? Wow, they're going to clean house right here. It's just going to be Jeps as that final pick goes out in middle, and it's going to be... That was really nicely played, actually.
Yeah, that was perfect by them. They managed to force the Uber on Jeps really early and then repush with that Kritzkrieg. Timon didn't quite catch the medic, but they've still got that crit advantage to work with. The spawns are all going to come in, so they're not going to push straight into last. Commander Thundercock repping the sniper on that right-hand side from the defender's perspective. So that shutter door is not a safe place to be peeking your head, guys. Everyone from the 50 Blessings team just dicing with death, dancing on the edge of getting their head ripped off their shoulders. But as soon as Chandos builds up this crits, in about 3 seconds, they'll be pushing with it. Where are they going from now?
Thundercock now rocking the sniper rifle, much more of a phallic object admirable. We'll be happy. As we see, I heard a headshot ring out there, but the crits is once again coming through. There's only one frag from that crit rocket, but he's warding off spawn nicely. Manages to pick up the medic as he tries to come back out. It's going to be a 2v2 to finish this off. A Demoman and a soldier versus medic. Medic Demoman. The medic does get taken down, so it's just Timon Rex now trying to clutch this point. It's about 75%, but he's going to take a direct pipe there just to win that defense for Rebels there. Thundercock spawns, and there's going to be no last cap point for now.
His precision penis, not strong enough. He is back on the field now with that scattergun, man. He's going to be delivering wide loads. But I just want to mention the raffle just ended there. Shout out to Steve-O, Kaza, and JJJ1, who were the winners. I'm sure there'll be another one coming up, but that is courtesy of ScrapTF and Jill putting on these raffles for you, the viewers on Twitch. But the action continues as our red team, 50 Blessings, come pouring through from Floral. They still have crits, but they're not close to getting it just yet. Still another 25% required. So Chandos is under big pressure, and Paprika just strolls in from behind and fires a rocket directly between his legs. Medic, but somehow 50 Blessings are making it work. They found the frags. They didn't need that crits, man. They don't even need a medic. They're just gonna big dog it.
Are Jeps and his team going to want to push out with this, though? The Rebels have a really large advantage, 75%. It gives them tons and tons of time to work with, but this is a really difficult point to push out from. It's actually quite easy to defend, but it's really difficult to push out, so you often get these repeated last pushes where the team holding second has quite a big advantage, but Jebs is actually the furthest one behind. They're not wanting to lead this forward with the Uber, but they are prodding into upper lobby, trying to catch anybody from 50 Blessings who peeks out there. Your bank may have been caught. Got a few decent rockets on him, but going to trade with Paprika surely there. They do have an opportunity. Chandos only on 70%.
Yeah, they're quite out of position here, 50 Blessings, and if they knew, the Rebels could definitely capitalize on it. They're definitely going to force them out here. Timur Rex out of that choke, but they had the Uber advantage, which they're actually going to lose now. We'll see in a few seconds how much of a percentage time that was that they lost, but is it still the crits? Is it still the crits that they're going to be up against? Because that will completely change the scenario. Nah, it looks
it's
like Uber.
Uber straight it here as red and blue both go shiny, but it's Akoff who gives away first blood there. 50 Blessings lose three players in the blink of an eye. Mitoki, Irhani, oh, they're all going down now. It's just Chandos left alive right now, and he's being swarmed by blue players. That was an absolute mauling there, despite being a fairly even Uber trade, Saito.
Yeah, they completely wiped, and they're going to be rolling that one forward. 50 Blessings putting up no defense, and it's a heartbreak round for them on the cards, because they had the opportunity to push last and make this 1-1, and instead the Rebels, led by Commander Thundercock, are going to be able to come inside. And it is a crits on defense actually here from Chandos. He's loving that crits creek action, but they're not going to get it in time unless they take a forever pushing with the supercharge.
That's the sort of reckless play I like, because you know, you're in the situation where you know you're at a huge disadvantage. You're like, we're not going to have charge anyway to hold most likely, but if we do hold it, we're going to have crits, which could be like a huge momentum shift. So, you know, they're taking that little gamble here. It mightn't work out for them, but ultimately the choice of Uber not going to matter for this defense, because right now charge is available for Jips, and he's trying to encourage his players to push. They're walking the wrong way, though. They're getting their buffs dealt, and the longer they take the push here, the sooner that crits is going to be coming up. The Uber's been popped off early, and Chandos just needs to kite for a few seconds here to get his crits up. He could go laser beams here on Ahikoff, but Matoki's being focused from the other side. He switches his hands up, lets his heavy die, and the crits is being
he's
held
holding
here.
Holding it.
Look, Jebs and Embrace refuse to retreat, though. They're just going to step on the point. Can they clutch it? Jebs is trying as hard as it. The point's being body blocked, and that's going to be all she wrote for that push.
There's a bit of a poor play from Chandos there to hold on to the crits the entire time and then pop it off just to deal with the demo man and the medic right at the end, though. If you're going to hold on to it the entire time,
the point's
you
open.
Might as well.
Oh. Early runs in advance.
But now they don't have the... They have a crits advantage to work with, like a really sizable crits advantage, but they need to be using it, because if they don't push out with it here, they're stuck. They're in a really bad situation. I mean, they could have potentially switched off the medigun and still had time to build one up on the defense, because Jeps died so late there, but instead they're going to be running with that crits creek, and that puts a lot of pressure on Timon, or potentially Mitoki, to make some big picks and open things up here for a push out onto second.
This is a tough position to be in, Ali. You know, you've got crits you're holding last, you're forced to push. Like, how do you approach this?
Well, on a map that I've barely ever played, I wouldn't be the best person to ask right now, but it looks like the left-hand side is not going to be the best solution, actually. They're going to be met by Hype and Sticky Spam. It's going to be a 3-for-1 trade so far. Just one person down from Rebels team as they push on the last. Nice spam from Bullhawk making the space. It's going to be 2 left alive now versus 4. And the 3 remaining members of Rebels are going to push on at this point. They're going to pick up the frag. And we are going to go to 2-0. Much less sided than our first 2 games as well. So this is shaping up to be good.
That was the poison chalice there of having crits advantage on defense. They tried to push, but the fact that they already knew they had crits meant that they got absolutely mullered with Sticky's rep. Timon Rex is going to be pretty fast here. He's looking to contest Embrace on middle, but both demo men not going to walk forward here. They're just sitting back. And it looked, whoa, Bank getting shrek there by early, totally denied midair. And Commander Thundercock going to get first blood. Embrace finds Akoff as well.
Oh, the bomb in by Timon. He's going to try and get a load of damage out. Instead, gets annihilated in midair. He was going for Jebs, but he's on 34 health miles out of there as well. Only Mitoki left alive.
Shandos,
along
kill
with
yourself.
Shandos. Way behind the enemy team, into the kitchen, having a picnic there in the lovely little restaurant area. Blue coffee, it says on the table. So, look, that's delightful.
Get this, guys. The current raffle on Scrap TF. 4 unusuals, 3 keys, a golden Blutsauger, an Australian Blutsauger, and a pair of earbuds, all up for grabs. 4 unusuals.
Doesn't choufleur mean cauliflower? In French.
It does,
I'm looking at a little floral sign in the sunshine area. The what's it called? The flower shop. It's called the Petit Choufleur Flower Shop.
Yeah, my little cauliflower. It's like a cute name for your lover.
I'll have to use that one. But not after this last fight ends. Paprika still in the backside of this team. The heavy, it does eventually go down. He's doing a lot of denial work. But it looks like this is going to be a much more successful hold here. There's only 2 people alive left in Rebels. One now, he's going to go down. They're going to have this 50% advantage now to push him to second. And despite the fact that it's Uber, it is going to be a lot easier to take than last time. So they're just going to jump on the point. I think last time they pushed out, after he popped back Fritz to defend on last, he should have gone back in the spawn and changed to Uber. But no such worries this time. He's going to be on that Uber in the first place, and they're going to have this position. There are a lot of people coming forward, though, from Rebels. They're not going to contest. They're just going to hold out this midpoint.
Oh, Sancho, mon petit chauffeur.
I feel strangely seduced and at the same time violated. It's a classic experience with Admirable there. Many people have had that same experience. Some have been suckered in, but I remain unharmed.
TF2.
Absolutely, yeah, TF2. That's what we're here for, right? There's only 2 players alive from the Rebels, and they're escaping out. Jepson early, running away. They do have a sizable Uber advantage, so about 60%. Are they going to use it? Are they going to try and go forward? Are they going to be ballsy with this defense? They can link up with Paprika and maybe cause some havoc. They got their Uber in about 5 seconds. I want them to go into them here. They're baiting all of 50 blessings in. They're 50 meters too close. Come on, Paprika. Deal the damage. Here we go. The Uber pops. Paprika with a huge bomb there. Trying to get onto Chandos. He's on 6 health. Will get caught there by early. And the rest of 50 blessings all up in the choke point. This could be disastrous for them.
Commander Thundercock picking up a couple of frags dancing around, but it's only a cough remaining alive. He has realized that wouldn't be a good engagement to take 1v6. He's going to retreat and regroup with his respawning medic, Chandos. He and Erhani are playing up there on that high ground at 2, but they're going to retreat into the lobby, much safer position to hold. But it seems like they're not even going to contest second. They're already behind that roller door and on the low ground, which is like, it's tough to come out there if you're not already on two. So they're going to be looking to set up a defense on last. A bit of a forward hold, though. Sticky traps on lower from Timon. Commander Thundercock is fearless, though. Oh, he runs in and runs out, though. He senses something is up. Timon's trying to control that little balcony area, though, but he's being pressured hard. His teammates didn't stay with him and cover him in that forward hold. He's been beat out. He's gone down. And still 25% Uber required for Chandos. They need to buy some time here. This heavy weapons guy from Eikoff might be enough. He's got the Tomislav out recently buffed in the gunmetal update. Chandos trying to get that charge. 95%. The Uber's already feed it here for Rebels. Chandos is going to do it. He's popped it off. And it looks like they didn't even need it. They already had 4 frags. And they're looking for more here, Ali.
Yeah, Jep's just running out, down to 40 health. He almost had an amazing... it was Chandos who almost amazingly survived on mid, but the medic's so far doing good. I think have we seen any dropped Ubers today?
I don't think so, actually.
I've never actually seen a dropped Uber. I don't know what those look like.
Yeah, it was from your POV and you're looking at the kill cam instead of actually watching a dropped Uber. Now, these medics are playing up to better than prep standards. Chandos making sure that he dies before he gets the charge instead of dropping every single time. But he's going to be pushing forward with the rest of his team. Ikoff is going to be pretty weak there, but he's healing him back up and they're going to be powering forwards. It's 3v3. Oh no, they're dropping
Paprika
even more.
Oh, he launches the medic, but whiffs the airdrop. Paprika's trying to chase down Chandos, but Chandos has support from Irhani and he will live to tell the tale. But it looks like their contest of middle has ended there.
It's just been crazy, these fights so far.
I'm
loving
take a breather, guys.
The scout pairing so far, though, for Commander Thundercock and early are just winning out in these fights. I'm totally behind it.
I'm just waiting for Commander Thundercock to have a huge moment because I want to shout his name at the top of my voice.
Commander Thundercock, he's the guy who's always in there first, and early is doing well to being on time for being in the fight too.
They're going to be
just feeling each other out now, feeling out Commander Thundercock. Damon's been juggled in though, and Chanos might have to save him here with the Uber. Disastrous for them. They need to find somebody, but Jepson Bahawk can just rotate around instead, actually taking the Uber straight into them. Going to be able to find Damon with that much better Uber charge, but now they need to make an entrance into the second point, and I don't think 50 Blessings are going to be able to put up a defense. There's 13 minutes, 2-0, and it looks like they're going to relinquish their hold on the lighthouse and fall all the way back to last. The Demoman's going to get spawned in time, but are you wanting to roll this forwards if you're the Rebels?
You definitely are.
Chandos gets caught as well.
Oh, cheeky sticky placement there for him. Embraces. Cut off his retreat. Oh, Commander Thundercock! Going absolutely huge. Gets the Demoman pick here. American Demo down right now for 50 Blessings, and, you know, Rebels, they can bide their time here. They're going to regroup and re-push. Still 5 seconds before Damon come up. They could just walk in, but they're going to wait for their charge. They don't want to leave anything to chance here, Seicho.
Absolutely not. They are going to be regrouping, and it looks like they're going to Uber in from their top right-hand side. Bohawk's actually running the black box conch, even after the slight nerf in the gunmetal update to the black box. They're going to be taking that Uber in on the right-hand side. He's building up his conch as well, but there goes the Devilman of Embrace taken down by Ehani. And Chandos is inside. This might be a disastrous Uber. The Thomas Lab Heavy going to be trying to dish out as much damage as possible. Only three of them left alive, but Hawk's trying to get onto some people. Jeps has gone down. As long as they can keep Chandos alive here. He's only on 50 health. No! But Hawk manages to find him with that last rocket. Chandos positioning poor for that situation. Paprika's hiding in the lobby as well. Gets Damon. Disastrous for 50 Blessings there, as they were intending to push out to lose their Demoman and their Medic, but big plays from both of the soldiers from the Rebels.
Ehani MVP so far on last points. That's the second time he's got an entry frag while the other team's been bringing into last. He's picked up a kill on that sniper. In that last fight, he got the kill, insta change to scout, picked up two more frags, taking down the Medic as well. Ehani is so far MVP. They need to be looking at Ubering early, Rebels, if they want to have a chance, or Uber from right side, so they've got less of a gap close, but They're losing bodies before the fights even begin, and they need to look at that.
Oh dear. Damon gonna join Mataki in the spawn queue. No Demoman and a soldier missing there as well. It's gonna be tough to force an entry here on the second, but they're trying to make it work. They are just fearless here in the attack. The scouts are trying to force their way out here, but Jeps is gonna keep healing Commander Thundercock and early, and they have managed to win that 2v1. Trying to focus down A. Actually, one of them goes to play the point there. They could have just gone for the frags, but it seems like it's going to work out in their favor anyway. Timon's back on the field now. It's just him and Chandos. They're forced to play the point. They have to block it, but they get juggled off. The cap comes in, and those humiliation frags are going to come in afterwards. But 3-0 here. Still 11 minutes left on the clock. It's all one-way traffic yet again, but this game feels close, guys.
We're not going to see another 5-0. Please, not another 5-0.
Not like this. Timon's going to roll out to mid, and Embrace is already there, trying to put up a load of stickies. Paprika and Commander Thundercock once again taking control of the enemy cafe. This time, though, Hue Bank is there to try and stop them. Paprika surfs under the Hellcat, and this is a duel to the death. Both of them with less than 10 HP, health down in the single digits, but Hue Bank doesn't have another health kit to fall back onto, and Chandos and his pocket have already been taken down. It seems like 50 Blessings are actually getting a lot of cap time, but surely the Reaper from Rebels here is just going to clean everyone up. Full wipe from 50 Blessings.
Yeah, it's just a really nice retake. Not more to say.
A fallen in the comrades. Commander Thundercock, he sacrificed himself on that mid fight, thrusting forward there, but it was for the benefit of his teammates. And now they've managed to take 2 points. Well, they haven't even taken middle yet, but they could potentially take 2 points off the back of that. And maybe being a little inefficient with their time here, and with Chandos coming up on the crits creep, time could be an important factor. They need to push immediately if they want to deny that crit threat. Here comes Cuckoo Bank, though. He gets launched up by a scattergun there just as he jumped. He got even more impulse, but totally ineffective there with that bomb. But they have waited so long, the crits is a threat now, guys.
Yeah, gonna see the sticky trap. Timon's been caught out a couple of times so far, but he's playing a lot further back this time, which is nice to see. But his stickies are entirely in view, so they're not doing anything now. And the Rebels are just gonna push in from this right-hand side. The scout Uber, they've actually listened to what I was saying, and they've not been picked off at all. They've actually not lost anyone so far in this fight, and it's quite a weak player. There is gonna be Timon Rex picking up the double pipe kill. He's gonna leave this quite close, but in the end, Rebels just have too many people. 4-0. 9 minutes to go. Can they do it? Can they make the 5-0?
I want to see the comeback. I don't want to see the 5-0. I want to see Commander Thundercock get Thundercock blocked and see Timon Rex and the 50 Blessings go through to the next round. So I'm cheering on the red team here. 50 Blessings, 50 Blessings. It's got too many syllables to make a chant out of. It doesn't matter. Timon is playing so aggressively on that side. And Early just takes a dump on his head. Early and Commander Thundercock playing around there. They're putting so much damage onto everybody. In for the play, potentially. Onto Jeps. Whiffs that last rocket. What a beef. Beef. And he's going to be behind as the last player alive from 50 Blessings. Not the best way to start off your 5-4 comeback, to be honest, but still possible.
He's in. He's going back for it. He lands one. Mate goes to 10 HP. That was a solid effort.
I was just about to, criticize him if that was a reckless play. Like, he clearly wasn't going to get it, but he came close there.
He didn't have much of a choice, did he? He was behind.
He could have just stayed alive, harassed a little bit, distracted. I don't know.
He's on the wrong side of the map.
Okay, I'm gonna retract my previous criticism.
Leave him alone!
Paprika already working his way under here. He's got the support of Commander Thundercock. Buffs are being dished out to everyone here on the Rebel side. And it looks like they want to make the push from lower. They're going to lead with Mohawk rocking the Black Box and the Conqueror there. Early's going to run in and die though. Oh, they've already lost two despite having this Ubercharge. They need to find frags ASAP. They do eventually manage to focus down the heavy. But just as the combo backs out, Paprika jumps in from the flank. Everyone's looking the wrong way. They thought the fight was over and Chandos goes down. Huge med pick coming out there against 50 Blessings. But we're just going to see Jep sit back here and build his Uber. He doesn't like to make these non-Uber pushes. Looks like they want to make sure they don't lose a single round here. These guys are ruthless. They want that 5-0.
It looks like it might be the case there. We see they almost picked up Timon as he was pushing far too aggressively onto second, but he manages to slink his way out. But they're just chucking bodies here forward. Timon going back in for that frag. They're not coordinated here. They had a scout that died 10 seconds ago. Once you've made that loss, you can't keep trying to commit, because even if you do get the medic, you've then got 5 versus sort of 3 or 4 in a pure deathmatch, which is definitely a fight I think they would take. But as it is, there's that Uber coming out, and there's still 20 seconds or so before Chandos is going to get his. They're just going to swarm all over this point. 2 frags each way at the moment. It could end up quite even. There's a medic on the point. The soldier gets taken down. Can't Earth
Chandos has got the crits! Oh no! He managed to get 2 swords for the crits.
1 HP.
Oh no!
No! The 5-0 happens again.
Probably a small mercy that the game ended before the full 30 minutes. That's going to help us catch up with the next round. This was round 2 of the TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble number 1, which we are covering from start to finish before jumping into the Gaming Grid's TF2 Fragfest semi-finals and finals, hopefully later on today. I mean, 6 hours of TF2, no problem, guys. But Saito, what's the status of the tournament right now? Where are we going next?
Where are we going next? I mean, there's 12 minutes left in this other game between Peraspera Ad Astra and the Chaotic Pups. The score is actually 2-1 to Peraspera Ad Astra. So, I mean,
we
could potentially be missing a wondrous game here, but they still have 12 minutes left if you want to jump into that. Or we can wait for round 3 to begin, which is on a completely different map. Is that a round, best of 1 on Badlands or something like that? Give me your opinion.
Follow the action.
Let's go for it, man.
Let's follow the action then. All right, let me give you that information, and in the meantime, I'll give you the radio cast. We're following Trox's team, Peraspera, de Vauxhall Astras, that we saw last time, and they currently have the Uber. They're going to be moving into last. They're trying to make it 3-1 here. Mr. Will and Snow and the rest of the Chaotic Pups are desperately trying to defend. Orton running that pyro is going to be blasting them back on the lower entrance, but he's actually going to get taken down. The Uber has faded, though, and the rest of Chaotic Pups fairly healthy, apart from their soldier that's just gone down as well. Now the heavy gets focused down. Mr. Will desperately spamming stickies onto the point, trying to defend it, but it's 4v3, and I don't think they're going to be able to hold it here. Actually, they're getting the picks. Only Disturbia and Bugsy are left alive, and this is a fantastic defense there from the Chaotic Pups with that non-Uber defense. Disturbia is coming back in, though. He wants to make something happen. No, he's going to get out of there. Orton's got a buff. There's no way he can contest. And the Vauxhall Astras hold on, keeping the score at 2-1 with 10.5 minutes remaining.
I'm right here with you now, bro. As we next map will be processed, by the way, in round 3. And then in the finals, we have a best of 3, which goes Gullywash, Badlands, and then Viaduct, I think.
Fantastic.
But yeah, either way, hopefully it won't be a 10-0 in the final. At least if this game's anything to go by, we're seeing. Looks like it's been a lot more closely knit thing.
Yeah, absolutely back and forth so far, but the Uber has been popped out of snow here, and they're getting a lot of damage onto Trox. I don't know whether they can find any of the Franks, though. The positioning from the rest of the Vauxhall Astras is fairly defensive. Buxer is only on 87% now, and Mr. Will desperately wants this frag. They know that they have to get onto that medic, otherwise the Uber repush is going to happen, but too little too late there. Mr. Will gets taken down, so it's going to be a bit of a task even to force them as they come in. The Vauxhall Astras looking good to push back in, and everyone from Chaotic Pups is still going forwards. They're going to get caught really badly here, Ali.
Yeah, I'm looking, it's quite a nice setup here. Medic, really nice positioning here. That's going to be Buxer from the game we last played. He is going to get forced by a scout from on the side. A frag that they're not going to pick up, and it's going to be quite a weak falling out here. This on 43 from Chaotic Pups, he's going to get taken down. It's just the medic alone on middle. He's got spawners coming through. It's actually Orton. He's in the enemy team's cafe. And the medic is still alive, Snow. He's going to get out, actually. That's ridiculous juking to get away from Golovonoji, Saito's favourite player from the previous game. Favourite player to pronounce, at least. But
I love that guy.
Orton, who was stuck in the Perisperas cafe, looks like he isn't going to be able to get out. He could have done them, but just his team was coming, but he wasn't aware of how close they actually were. So it is actually going to be a retake, possibly here for Celtic Pups. But Disturbia is still, and he's onto Mr. Will. Doesn't manage to take him down. Mr. Will, the demo there, that would have been a tide changer, but it looks like it's just going to have to set up for another mid onto second push. And yeah. They've got Uber advantage as well.
The Vauxhall Astras did not manage that at all. Admirable.
Oh, a huge Uber advantage here, though, for Chaotic Pups are coming through, but they get forced out by Big Golo. He's going to jump behind it into Floral. He's still a threat, but as Disturbia respawns, Crow goes down, so still only one scout on the field here for the Vauxhall Astras. They're trying to do that unenviable push out from the lobby, and they realize it's not worth it. They're going to go back here. They do have a huge Uber advantage. They've got time to wait for their spawns to come up 7 seconds before Golo and Crow are back on the field. Disturbia is going to play Sniper here. I don't know what he's expecting, but potential for suicide play here from Chaotic Pups. They might try and throw someone in to get that force out, but their position is a kind of a weird one. Are they playing for the wraparound here? Are they hoping that they push or they can go under?
They're actually going to take this force out into this lobby area, and they're actually making really good work of it. Trox picking up two kills, and Disturbia coming in at the last moment to pick up the third. Snow's still sort of 10 seconds or so off his Uber. He's going to back out to mid, playing it super safe. Orton is still the only player left in underneath, but he's going to be picked up too. Quite a clinical push out there from Perez, looking to extend the lead, but definitely not throwing it away like we've seen so many teams do so far in their last push out.
Look at this though, look at this, Ali. The Uber is about to come up from Snow, and they just got all of their forwards. Mr. Disturbia, surely gonna get caught here by Scene. No, Scene. Yes, Scene. No, Scene. Scene whiffs 1,000 rockets, and Disturbia just runs away. Interesting play by him, but over on the other side of the field, H is gonna be bombing in there. Great rocket onto Bugzer. Gonna land on his face. Oh, can't quite finish that frag though, as Bugzer lands on top of the health kit as well. They've thrown one of their players in the pocket, H, in order to get the two frags they needed, but
Mr. Will could have absolutely crushed there. H was the huge distraction in lobby. If he'd gone in as well into the lobby, that was like a 5k. That was YouTube material right there for sure, Saito.
Yeah, he definitely could have got all the frags, and Bugzer would have been denied the Uber charge as well. But now the situation is that the Vauxhall Astras have that Uber, and they're going to be pushing out from the top right-hand side with Gugulovnov leading the charge along with Trox. They're taking it forwards. Gogolovnichov is getting so much damage out here onto the pocket.
It's like you're draining.
There's another retake though. This is crazy. Their last holding potential is amazing. Their mid pushing potential is terrible. I don't know if they've realised this yet, but they've got another chance here now. It's going to be slightly more cursive because the Derby is going to come in. They are actually definitely going to be able to cap out this mid point. How long they can hold on to it is a different matter, because once again, they've got this mid point, but they're at an uber disadvantage, and Ihor is far too far forward. And again, they're out of position. If they use this uber properly, then they're just going to get completely destroyed again, once again, the Astras. And it's the scouts now coming forward, Linkstog and Orton. They're going to be straight onto the medic. Medic down to 125, picks up the health pack, and doing a really good job, the rest of his team, of fending them off at the moment. What a shot from Golo. And Mr. Will takes down Bugs. Oh, the long range. Oh, he got him. Oh, no.
In the meantime, a bomb in from Golovnichov.
Does anyone know CPR?
He doesn't manage to find the medic, though. Snow stays alive, serves that one away. And this is looking good here for the Chaotic Pups. They've got an opportunity to tie it up 2-2. They can just wait for their spawners. They have that huge Uber advantage. They push in from the on the right-hand side where nobody really is, but look at this positioning from Trox on Heavy. This is why this version of Sunshine blows, man. It's so difficult to push last when you've got a Heavy in that position. And the double choke point on the right-hand side, which the Demoman Ihor is making the best use of he possibly can by putting stickies everywhere. It's going to be a really difficult last push for the Chaotic Pups, but they need to make it. There's only 4.5 minutes left. They need to tie this up 2-2.
That was so good. If Will was piped onto Bugs there in that last round, has won them the fight, it would show from this Uber fight here, but they're not making much at the moment. They've got one frag. Will is too low, though, and that Heavy is just doing so much work. It's just the two soldiers left in at the moment, and Scout Orton. He's trying to run forward. He does actually take a Heavy down, and H is in from behind. It's just Ihor left. He's got a spawner in 6 seconds. This could actually be it. 2-2, boys. 2-2. We are actually a draw and not 4-0 with 4 minutes to go.
Apart from 0-0, this is the first draw we've seen for the whole tournament.
Absolutely, so admirable. What? Who's going to be winning this mid-fight? Who's going to have the momentum with 4 minutes left?
I think it would be Golo von Ogli, who is my pick to watch on this mid-fight. Trox is usually stealing his thunder, but I think he is the hidden weapon here. He's going to jump forward. He jumps directly up into the air. The Hawk's jumping.
What a
eats
shot.
A big air shot. Unlucky Golo. Orton goes down on the other side, though. And as this mid-fight progresses, the team with the most scouts might be looking fearful, but Disturbia and Crow both go down. So things are looking like full speed ahead here for Chaotic Pups. They're not even going to leave anyone to cap middle. They're just going to go for the complete wipe here. There goes Bugzer. Ihor will manage to just kill off Scene 1, 2, 3 before he goes down himself, but now the cap begins on middle. Mr. Will and Snow pushing forward here a little bit, but they're going to think twice about that. They're going to just park the bus here on CP2/4. They wait for that cap to come in on middle. Crow respawned on Engie on last here, and Disturbia playing Sniper. It's the Highlander full turtle here, guys.
And the triple off-class defense. And they haven't... Oh, they are getting the Heavy in there in that same position. Golagolarov-Nikov is going to get himself in the position, but this time with the Tommy Slab, so he'll be doing mad damage from miles away. The Sentry as well in the lower. I cannot see this push working. The defense is so strong. All they need is to shift the heels around a little bit and Deservia to swap off. But the Uber Charge is going to come in from the bottom again. This is the one that worked last time. H is going to be blasted so far up in the air. They need to start getting damage down. Golagolarov-Nikov has moved away from his fantastic position for some odd reason, and they found the Sentry already. This could be looking good. They're stacking the point. They're trying to get some time on it as they can. And there goes Chaotic Pups taking a 3-2 lead. They're on the comeback.
Man, we must be unlucky charms.
Golo's heavy play left a lot to be desired there. He definitely could have clutched that for his team, so he's going to have to dig deep here on this mid. I'm not going to watch him this time after his gifted an airshot to the enemy team last time, but I am looking at H as he bombs forward. He's trying to contest the enemy demo here. Ihor on the right hand side. Meanwhile, wow, Trox has gone in and killed off Snow immediately, but H is trying to get that medic pick. He's going to jump forward. His second rocket isn't good enough, but his third is reloaded. Will get the pick, and it's both medics down here, but look at the bodies hit the floor right now for Per, Aspera, and Astra. Only Ihor remains alive. And Chaotic Pups, man, wow, they have found that fifth gear for sure.
Yeah, and the Vauxhall Astras have just completely lost faith in themselves. Vauxhall Astra losing that fifth gear, the fifth gear, nowhere to be seen. They're in reverse. Yes, I am.
I don't think Admirable made that intentionally, but then you just said it again and laughed at yourself.
If I can't laugh at myself, who will? Who will, Ali?
I don't know, you manage it right. But either way, they're just tired of being slow-paced here, the Astros. They're not going to sit on last for another push-in, which they're possibly going to lose. And they're just instead going to go in. Orton gets destroyed trying to make the aggressive play. And taking the right option here, the Chaotic Pups are going to fall all the way back out to their second. They are actually at an Uber disadvantage, and it's really the prerogatives on the Astros to push forward and really make use of this, because their demos of stickies aren't actually going to have much of an impact. They've jumped around really well. They're making a lot of space. Trox is really low. He's going to go down, but that's a pretty, not such a bad price to pay. And they might actually trade this soldier. Nope, Heitch survives on 4 HP, makes his way to the health pack. Disturbia now pushing them back, but the momentum shift has been completely in favor. There's 5 seconds left, though, before The Uber will come up for the Chaotic Pups, so they need to push now or never. The Uber has come through, so this fight might not go so well. They're just letting people, oh god, they've got Uber. Oh god, what are they going to do? This does actually look pretty bad. The Heavy is once again taken up, this time by the Chaotic Pups. And this is a pretty poor position, but at the moment, Golovognyov has picked up two frags. Crow is going to be in, but the time is going to run out. And 3-2 is the final score.
That's how you do it, Golo. Orton giving the Tomislav masterclass there on last. Just peppered them with hot lead throughout that push. It does end 3-2 to Chaotic Pups. Sideshow, have we already got a next game lined up?
We do indeed. Rebels versus Citroman's Mike Care package is on its way. That is round 3 on CP Process. I'm going to be heading in there right now. I'll give you guys the information as well. Just give me one moment there. So Rebels is the team with Captain Thundercock. Commander. That's an absolute slight on him.
De-ranking him.
Yeah, I apologize profusely. He's not a captain, he's
a
commander.
Do you have no respect for the chain of command, Sideshow?
Master and Commander Thundercock. The Citramind Mike Care package. They're the guys we saw in the first round, 5-0. I'm launching straight into it. It's played 2.5 minutes already, and it's still 0-0. So the team... Wait, actually, they might not have begun. No, they haven't begun. Okay, right, I understand what's going on. They haven't actually started yet. I'm a fool.
Whilst we're waiting, head over to your Twitch chat and type exclamation RAFFLE. And you will be presented with a link to a currently active raffle on ScrapTF, courtesy of Jill, in which you can enter. There's currently 372 people entered. And the raffle ends in 1 hour, 10 minutes, according to the bot. He's not lying either. This is the one I mentioned earlier. 4 unusuals up for grabs, a pair of buds, 3 keys, and a strange Australian Bloodsauger. Formerly a great medic weapon, now just, you know, left to gather dust on the weapons rack there. But there will be multiple winners as well, so get involved, guys. And... we should take a minute, I guess, Sideshow, to shout out the sponsors of the tournament as well.
We absolutely should. That's tf2pickup.net. Check out their blog as well, blog.tf2pickup.net. And, we've gone live as well. I wasn't even paying attention, but we have actually gone live.
I'm trying to sign up for the raffle.
blog.tf2pickup.net, whitelist.tf, and serve.me.tf as well. But on this midfight, actually, it's an interesting one. It looks like the Rebels are taking the better end of it, but what a nice shotgun there, actually. FD hitting a meat shot to take down early. He might be able to get Jeps. He actually forces the Uber. Fat play from FD. Hello,
right,
team.
I'm back in. No fear.
I don't mind taking it.
I haven't signed up for my raffle yet, but the hit. See the Rebels. Formerly in blue, now going to be playing in red. That's going to be a mindfuck. As Citramine's Mike's Care package are going to push out. Citramine leading the way himself. He's going to bomb straight onto the medic. That was really nice. Jax gets taken down in choke. Catches the surf, but it's not enough. And Citramine's Mike's Care package are going to be moving forward. MCP, is that okay? Why would you name a team after yourself? That's just going to lead to so much confusion.
Look, man. The team name is Citramine's Mike's Care package. Fucking deal with it.
Yeah, but admirable, what's this tag? It has one too few M's. Surely it's really Citramine's Mike Care package, you know, like C-double-M-C-P.
It's all one word though, Citramine, although he does have a capital M in the middle there. That's just his artistic license side joke.
I see. Well, he is going to be leading the charge through that. No, he's not. It's going to be FD, but the team is leading the charge through PC, and they're going to try and use this Uber advantage. It's 50%. That gives them 20 seconds to work with to get onto Jeps. Jeps has spotted out the danger, but FD's so high up in the air there, dodging all of those air shots. And surely Commander Thundercock going to get caught, only on 43 health. Nice pipe from Raider to take him down. They found 3 with that Uber charge. That's plenty. They just need to be streaming to last. Leave 1 on the point. Walkie's going to take that, and the rest of them are pushing in here onto Process Last. Going to try and make the first round count. Paprika down, floating onto the point here. Jeps in early. Only ones left alive can't stop the point. 1-0 to Citramine's Mike Care package.
Jeps. finished that round on 91%. Early was frantically trying to build there with Boss and Basher out at the end, but he had to kind of leave him to try and delay the capture of the last point, but there was no one spawning in time, so Jeps didn't manage to pick up that Uber. Could have been quite close otherwise. It was the Embrace rocking the really fast rollout though, but Raider's already beaten him there. He must have gone super fast. And it's going to be a fairly passive mid so far until Free-Through Ivan Clean. He's going to get completely exploded on Choke, jumped into six players, then he gets 50 damage. As Early now tries to follow his teammate's lead and jumps onto the rock, gets some good pressure, creates a lot of space for his team. And everyone except the single scout, Walkie, is going to be forced back into Choke. Walkie's still in, his team has completely abandoned him, which is, I don't know, kind of strange. It was only four alive. Now they're choosing to come back in. The Wiz has been the weirdest, longest drawn out mid fight ever. As Embrace got the drop!
Oh, Thundercock in there with the drop.
Thundercock!
Thundercock with the cock drop, and down goes Costin. He's gonna fall. Paprika and Jeps have been pressured back really hard though, and Jeps actually drops his pocket. There's only him and a scout left alive. Oh, he's put himself in a bad situation here. He's forced to drop out, and they're gonna wait for these respawns. Surely gonna push back in. But are they gonna manage to block it, or are they gonna have to give up mid here to Citramine's Mike Care package?
Damn. Even the drop from Commander Thundercock can't stop this aggression.
They are winning the war here. They lost a couple of battles on the way, but Sirimans is gonna bomb in. He's looking for that force. He's in onto Jeps. Jeps has walked into the corner. Classic admirable move there. It has to pop to save himself. And now with this Uber well and truly kited, Sirimans might care package. They're thinking of going in again, but then a quick look at the scoreboard, they realize they're two down with Feed and Sirimand still residing in that spawn queue, and they're gonna have to endure some pressure here. Embrace is already poking ahead. He sees it's pretty clear around Choke, but I think they're gonna walk back. Okay, they're scared of the Uber. This is what it is. Even though they had that man advantage, you know, maybe you would have sacrificed a couple of players there for the force, but they're more confident playing the six here. We're gonna see the regroup on middle from Rebels.
They're going to get caught if Citramine's care package move quickly, if they bust out, but FD doesn't realize where they are. FD has lost his way. He needs a kind of navigational device to find where the rest of the Rebels have disappeared to. Oh, and Embrace with the Sticky Trap finds Feed. It did a lot of damage there to the Demoman of Raider as well, but that was poor from them, and now the Reaper is surely going to be coming in from the Rebels.
Yeah, they just ubered their soldiers through on point, just spamming forward. Thundercock was a bit out of position to make the big flank plays, but he's right in the front line now. Walkie's actually hiding in sewer, no one's gone around there. If he comes around the back now, he could definitely take the medic. He's still standing there though. There's a soldier pocket randomly spammed out there. And they've just had to leave two on mid for the sake of capturing this last point. But if Walkie walks out of the sewers, that he's actually going in the right place now. He could get up on the medic, he's right behind them now.
Paprika's seen him.
Jets. Oh, he didn't get any damage.
Big Paprika saw it. He was coming out from the lower PC there. He just jumped up to deny with some spicy rockets. I think they might continue to push here. Come on, guys. A little bit of aggression. I know they have Uber, but you have man advantage. Do it, team.
Well, Hawk's still running that conch, and he's going to be thinking about popping it off. Here we go, in with the conch, and they're going to be... Oh, no, he's holding on to it. He's getting ready just for them to get the Uber charge, actually. Jep's just building the last few percent, and as they come in now, he's going to do that stupid thing, isn't he, where they use it in the middle of the Ubers. Oh, he's done it. This really triggers me whenever people do this. Oh. He's completely wasted his conch, and he actually goes down as well. He should be using that for the repush. Maybe.
Oh, my God! He's using
an insane pipe. His pipes there denying everybody off the point, single-handedly winning it there for the Rebels.
That was beautiful. That was beautiful. Just piping an Ubered player right in your face is completely against all the logic that we're taught, but in that circumstance, it actually won him the point. So moving on to this next middle, Raider once again is turning up there earlier than Embrace. Stickies haven't managed to get any damage down so far yet, so it's going to be the scouts actually that try and make the impact. Paprika goes flying, but only manages about 60 damage onto the medic. As of Citramine's My Care package, as now it's going to be Citramine's My Care package to actually take the initiative, get up top. Medic down to 50 HP, gets taken down. Citramine himself making the big plays there. Are they going to chase? It looks like Raider's trying to get forward. Early hiding in sewers. Nah, he's going to back out. Nope, he's not going to back out. He's going to take this one-on-one versus the soldier. But FD comes forward.
Another fat meat team. Shot.
Calls his boys. Yeah, man, he's hitting them all.
Yeah, he's got that shotgun aim there from FD. Stands for Fat Dick, obviously, and he's just whipping out that shotgun whenever he likes, slamming the lead into people. They're going to be moving forwards with this Uber charge as well. Who are they going to lead it with? It looks like Feeded wants to feed in that rollout area, they'll have to hold on
to
him.
He wants to feed on a fat dick.
I fear this.
Where's
could...
Commander Thundercock watches?
Sprinkled with paprika.
Oh no!
FD and Citramide, they're gonna lead it in, they're gonna focus down Commander Thundercock instantly on that heavy class. The engineer switched off as well as Paprika and Bahawk are trying to defend this, but the cap time! Oh, both of the scouts going down actually there to the double soldier aggression. Raider onto the point, but it's all up to Citro. Oh, I think he almost accidentally capped the point there and cost him the last man alive. It is a successful defense from the Rebels, and the score is 1-1. This is a tight match.
Yeah, a long spawn here for Kostin and Sitraman. They mightn't get forward spawn. It's going to be close. Oh, denied. So no healings here. This should be 2 points for free as Rebels take control of Spire. They're just kind of regrouping themselves. They have been a little hesitant previously to push, but they're starting to walk forward. I believe you can do it, guys. And again, Walkie, the man hiding in the sewer here. And it looks like Rebels are happy to slow the pace down. There's still 21 minutes left. No need to rush into anything. They're going to sit here and build their Uber charge. They have that advantage, a good 30%, 40% almost. And they're playing very conservatively here.
Yeah, do they not keep track of the fact that Kostin died in that last fight? It's just Paprika who's quite far forward at the moment. But I mean, if he stays there, his team is all the way back on second, that they wouldn't even be able to contest if FD jumped round and came in behind them right now. It is going to be Thundercock and Paprika.
Talk a little bit about that. You know, like, this is the, you know, it's the open rumble. Players who are, you know, climbing the competitive ladder. How do you calculate that advantage, Ali?
You just kind of hope. At least that's how I managed it for a while. But STV Stats is kind of helping us here. They Red has lost their Uber advantage 17 seconds so far, as Kostin now has his. And only now it looks like Jeps is like pushing his team forward to this choke. But it seems like, I don't know, they really don't want to give up this point. Maybe lack of confidence in their own pushing ability. I mean, in a lot of games, you see at the lower skill levels, aggression is normally the way forward. Like, you can do really well, and being able to counter aggression is often a higher skill activity. It's Jet actually does
force.
Get forced. He was scared of the air shot.
That was a pussy pop.
He was scared of the air shot.
But he missed the air shot and then popped afterwards when he landed on the floor.
Poor reaction.
Yeah, he has 3 second reaction times. But that's really opened the door here for Citra Mind's Mike Care Package to really push this through the choke point and try and get a lot of frags. Embraces caught out, juggled up in the air. Oh, and a weak shot from Feed. It finishes him off. Walkie and the rest of them are going to stack that point and move forward still with that huge Uber advantage. They know that it takes 40 seconds to build up the Uber, and Jeps has not had near enough time. Going to be leading it in here with Feeded and FD trying to get all the frags, but Paprika's building up that sentry on the right as well. Going to be just slowly chipping away at people. They need to get on the point, though, and they can't quite manage it. That is 2-1, 19 minutes remaining, Ali.
Yeah, they just took that point through the sentry there. I can't remember whose sentry it was, but the engineer was just sat in support and waiting for his sentry to die to change back. And in the end, I mean, Citramine's Mike Care Package was just like, well, he's going to stay in spawn, so why don't we just not kill this entry, and then there's just one less person to deal with. And that ended up working for them. This is massive aggression here. Coming out from the Rebels is actually going to completely deny the Demoman any space, but Citramine's going to come in before long and pick up that frag, and they're completely controlling this top area. Bohawk's going to jump up, but he's not going to get anything done. And now moving over to this left side, Effie and Feeder are trying to push forward. Bohawk, there is now the man up top. He really needs to make use of this position. He's not really doing anything. Embrace has been healed up, though, and he's going to come across the point. And Citramine's Mike Care Package wisely recognizing their disadvantageous position and getting out there. Commander Thundercock staying alive for this middle. Gonna look for him to make the big plays that's gonna force Kostin.
Yeah, Commander Thundercock with a 2k there, but it seemed like Jeps had a tight grip on him. Then when I left him too far away. Come on, keep a straight face, fucker. But great protection of his medic there as Uber versus Uber, as we all have a nervous breakdown here.
Oh, Breaker with the bomb of a lifetime coming in there and sprinkling spice all over Kostin. Absolutely annihilated him. But and it's just a collapse on the rest of their team. Kostin tried to hold on to the Uber for a little too long, and he's just jumping on his head. This is easily just going to be another round. It's going to be 2-2. There's absolutely no way that Walkie can do anything. He's miles behind everybody. There's not a chance of a defense there from Citramine's Mike Care Package. And it's going to be 2-2 onto our fifth mid. They are showing that they've got those individual plays to throw into the mix.
Choo-choo-choo-choo, all aboard the comeback train, baby. I'm looking forward to this. I'm looking forward to what Admirable's got cooking in his brain for Thundercock's next big play. As we see, once again, Paprika going for this fast rollout. It's really paying dividends on this mid so far. They won the last one just because heat of that early aggression completely took Raider out of the game. Early is a bit alone, though, on the left-hand side. Bohawk's only just now joining him. Does take down FD, sends him to his final destination. As Paprika is now on low HP, Feeders manages to take him out. It's quite a fair fight here. Only 3 versus 4, now 2 versus 4. And once again, Kostin getting out. He's doing a really good job on these mid-fights. It's just the big plays from Rebels are actually like forcing the fights after the fact.
Yeah, they're going to be moving that one forwards. Yeah. And what did it feel like, Admirable? Tell me what it felt like.
It felt like the Turtleman's Mike Care package scouts got a little bit beaded there by Paprika. They tried to run at him through a choke point, and he and Commander Thundercock just minced them up. Saito, continue, please.
Commander Thundercock's taking a battle there with the eponymous Citroën. He's not going to manage to actually win a frag out there. Pulled up there, it was early, and Kostin going to pop off his Uber. It's going to be a slightly better for Jeps, but he's not connected to anybody, and he's going to be dropping people left, right, and center. They're going to pop it in a terrible position here for Jeps as well. Oh, dreadful play from the medic, unfortunately. A bit of miscommunication within the team. It'll be rough for them to try and pick up any frags off the back of this. Oh, they are going to just catch Walkie there with the tip of the Thundercock. And Paprika gets a frag onto Citro as well. But Citro Mind's mic care package are going to be able to come through on top of this one.
Oh, early jumping from rock to the upper area, catches a little long-range air shot, manages to survive though, jumps back for buffs, and Commander Thundercock has been unsheathed. He's running forward here. He's chasing down Kostin. Kostin doesn't know where to go. He's thinking of going roller door. Walkie's just coming in time, and Thundercock is just going to regroup here with the rest of his team. They still have this two-man advantage. Those spawns are coming in though. There's a fat dick back on the field. Feed It is coming up now as well. And with that slight uber disadvantage, we're probably going to see a little bit of a stalemate here, Ali.
We are. I'm looking for a big flank coming up. I think they haven't really watched the sides very well so far, Stitch Minds. Like, there's only been the pushes through the middle. I'm looking for a push around the right-hand side. Maybe we haven't even seen any off-classing either. We haven't seen a spy all day. Is that true?
Yeah, I haven't seen one, for sure.
Like, teams need to switch this kind of thing up. But it's not like the last pushes haven't been successful. Like, I don't know. I think, have we even seen a stalemate at last? I think teams have always just been good at pushing through these Ubers, so there's not much to be left to desired. I think if they play this right...
Oh, Paprika's in! He's going for the force! But Kostin doesn't even take a single point of damage there. But it looks like Rebels want to continue to throw players in here. Despite their force bomb not working, they're going to just keep throwing bodies at the problem. It's not working for them. They've lost 3 right now, and they're just in disarray here. Already, Jeeps is backing up the choke, whilst Bohawk and Embrace continue to fight in the lobby. They're finding frags, though. Embrace watches Bohawk die in front of him, and he's going to join him now. As a fat dick moves forward there on the upper, he's going to drop down below. He's looking to jump up here. He's going to contest Paprika on the point. Early's coming in to put some buckshot into him, but it looks like Rebels are going to back out. Just as I say that, Paprika comes flying in. He arches around, but doesn't really get much done. He's going to jump into the big blocker there on choke as well, but does manage to survive. Wow, he's crazy.
He's going for a parkour masterclass. He's jumping from block to block, just showing off his rocket jumping skills. He reckons this is RJ_beef. But it's 2-2 here for both of these teams. The pressure really is on. They've got 13 minutes left. Enough time to really take it a little slower. There's going to be a bit of a stalemate situation here, I think, as both teams face off against each other, trying to decide what's the best way of tackling the situation. But it looks like it's actually the Rebels who want to prod through this. Here comes Bohawk, but it's actually Paprika once again in with an attempt onto the medic, but they just didn't have any information as to where Kostin was. And he's still alive. Paprika's still dancing around at the back as the Ubers are traded. And it looks like they're getting all the frags on the non-Uber people. This is going to be a bad, bad situation for Citroën's care package. They need to flee out of there and try and put up some kind of defense on last.
Yeah, Thundercock looking like just pushing the front lines, looking to try and insert himself into this combo. He's only going to get a couple of damage down. I don't think he realizes how low FD is though. He's down to sort of 80 HP. He could definitely have taken that one-on-one, but they do have numbers up now, and that heavy is definitely going to force them back out of that corridor position. They've got a slight advantage, and they are building ferociously with this Boston Brasher. So They do have the pyro though, Walker. He is recognizing the disadvantage, so it's up to Rebels now to spot this and pick their position to push carefully, because otherwise that pyro is going to completely wreck them. And he changes off pyro.
Yeah, he's actually changed off. Citramine and Feeded running over that right hand side. But they may well get caught, because it looks like the... Jeps and Bohawk looking like they want to push from the mid left-hand side. The UBA is popped off. Early going to be taking it forwards along with Bohawk there. They found the frag and Costa on 99% is going to be able to pop it off, but they've already lost their Devilman and the Scout. There's a big potential here. Oh, Thundercock on 15 health is going to eat a rocket just at the end.
Oh my god. He just steps on the point there. They are... Oh, they didn't know where to look. But Paprika with the big play to give his team the lead here, 3-2 in favor of Rebels as we go to the sixth mid fight. 11 minutes, 30 seconds left on the clock. It's anyone's game.
Embrace has utterly whiffed his rollout though. 24 health sat there just waiting for the heals. That's going to put the Rebels in a bad situation, but they are 3-2 in the lead. They just need to play this a little bit slower perhaps, but the double soldier aggression is going to be putting out a ton of damage onto everybody, but it's actually result in them losing one of their people. They just need to play aggressively now. The Citramind mic care package, but they've taken a little too long about it. Now as Walkie and Citramind go aggressive, Embrace may end up getting picked off, but they're just splitting their damage onto all of these different people, not focusing down targets, instead just trying to damage everybody and force them out. But it's the frags you need, otherwise they can carry on doing damage to you. And everybody here from Rebels has been put down to less than 5 health at some point, it seems, but they all stay alive. They only managed to get one frag, even though they did a butt ton of damage there on that mid fight.
Pretty sure I counted 4 people from Rebels go below 10 HP at some point in that fight. Just a bit unlucky.
Yeah, there is that, but it's also like how you allocate your focus fire. Oh, Custom's juggling up in the air and forced to pop it off as Paprika does another fantastic bomb in. He's absolutely on fire there, Paprika. And Citramine care package are going to have to repel this Uber.
They've decided to push immediately here and they've been rewarded with a frag. Citramine goes down and the rest of our blue team have just retreated. Feeder's trying to take a peek here. FD tries to come out as well at the same time. I'm not sure what they're hoping to achieve here, but they are going to make it slightly easier for Rebels to push if they want to do so. There's another frag given away for free here, and it seems like frustration is creeping into the Citramine's mic care package team's mindset. They need to just focus here, take a few deep breaths, guys. Reset. This is a slim advantage, though. I wonder how hard we're going to see Rebels push off of this one, or will it be the classic Paprika bomb?
They're really building very hard with Early there, smacking himself in the face with the Boston Basher in order to take a lot of damage and thus build the Uber charge quicker. They do have it now. It's 20% advantage, costing only on 80%, but that doesn't give them much time to work with, and that opportunity is fast fading. The window of opportunity has slammed in their faces. It's an openable window with shutter doors, and it is now closed. Paprika going to take the fight with a feed on the right-hand side here as the rest of the Rebels try and force their way in. The Uber is popped, and the counter Uber comes out of costing. The first frag is onto Paprika, but the positioning is pretty good here for the Rebels.
Yeah, well, that's good. And there's now 3 of your team in there, soon to be 4. Yeah, positioning was good, but half of their team decided to leave them. So it is just going to be Jeps getting out alone, completely abandoning his team. Probably to the better degree, in the sense that if they're going to lose, they might as well lose and keep Ubers in check. Just going to be spam rockets from Paprika, stopping that coming out. But yeah, that fight did look good. I mean, if you do Uber in and it's going to be trade, you want to get that high ground up behind. But just not enough of half their team decided to back out, so I'm going to put that down to a miscommunication, but otherwise that could have been a one.
I think they just
fight.
hadn't done the damage. It was like when the Ubers faded there, Costin had done a great job of keeping his team all like on full health or even buffed, and right at the key moment when the real fight was beginning, it was already stacked heavily in their favour. We're back to another little Uber versus Uber steelmate here. FD's looking for a buff. He is perhaps thinking of jumping in. Citraman's got one through, but it's Paprika jumps in, gets immediately denied there. Huge air shot from Citraman, feeded stins the frag though. And FD goes in at the same time, so both soldiers down a piece here. Thundercock's coming in from the flank, but meanwhile the main Uber Force comes in. There's flashes being put all around here, but the back cap is on as our blue team, Citraman's mic care package, try to go forward. They realise they have to turn around and deal with Bohawk and Commander Thundercock. And it seems to have just petered out here. Early and Jeps are on middle, but they're all the way on the red side. Commander Thundercock is still in here. He's being hounded. Here comes Paprika, though. He's going to use Thundercock's distraction. He's jumped up top. Now, Sitterman is trying to jump up to contest. He's tagged that Scout and Soldier, both super weak here. And it just a key rocket there. Sitterman jumps up, creates the space for his team, denies that high ground. And the contest here in middle continues. And in fact, CMCP have taken control of the point. They're looking to just drop the hammer here. There's more frags available to them if they want to go ham. They're going to jump forward. They're trying to send players in here. They need to be faster. They could kill them all here, but they're hesitating. They're just walking through. They're catching spam. The spawns are coming in as well. FD, jump, buddy, jump. They're going to let them escape. Unbelievable. I'm disheartened, team. I'm disheartened.
I can hear it. We're just letting the silence through. Is it disappointed enough yet? I think it's good. All right. So now we're going to see two Uber. So now we're going to see two Uber versus Uber. They're going to opt to go through this right-hand side. That heavy is going to do a lot of long-range damage, but hopefully if they can get into this right-hand side quick enough, they'll be able to rotate all the way around the top. Neither Uber popped yet. This is the right way to push. And they're completely up. If they take that heavy down, oh, the heavy got taken down before the Uber even started. This is looking bad, actually, for the Rebels. FD's on the floor. Medic needs to save. Nice pop there from the medic. Costum, that's it. The reverse Uber is going to come out from Jens, but three of his team is already down. It's now 3v3 on this last point. There's a couple of seconds Uber left. Paprika was behind. I don't know where he was, but he's just going to be coming in from this rollout area now. And, oh, this is getting so close. It's just Raider left against, but the spawner of Commander Thundercock is going to come in. Going to completely block off any attempt to
here
win
comes
this
Walkie. Walkie's in. He's onto the point. He's already taken down Embrace with the help of Raider.
And I was watching Thundercock. Thundercock was trying to flank around and get the people as they were running out, but Walkie was already in that lobby and already pushing on to last. So, oh man, you can't take those kind of risks. The point is like 50% capped and the new spawner's coming.
My mother always said, never take a risk with a Thundercock, and she was right. Onto this 7th mid. Citro's going really aggressive, actually trying to get onto Embrace. Embrace on the 13 health, 6! Just getting chip shot away from the other side of mid by Walkie there, who does get a frag. Nice air shot onto Bahawk, but he's still fairly healthy, and they're going to be able to come forwards despite losing their Devon Man really early on.
Onto the medic, taking down 60, 79 HP. Can he get away? No way, Costa gets away from this. Nice by Paprika there. Took him 3 rockets, but that flank play completely won the mid for Rebels.
Yeah, they're going to be able to pick up second off the back of this as well. Nice rocket by Bohawk, and Commander Thundercock can come in for the flank. Great play by him, going balls deep into the enemy team.
I mean, I don't think you even meant to do that. I think it just runs naturally.
I've been cooking that one up for ages.
That was beautiful.
I feel like I'm underperforming in the innuendo department.
The game, the bar has been raised here. Here comes the Uber though, bottom left. There's already a level 2 sentry gun there in position from Faded. Uber gets popped off, sentry gun goes down, but they've yet to find an actual frag. They've killed off that 7th man, and it's Sitterman, in fact, that goes down first. Walkie now playing heavy weapons guy on the point. He's got no heals. Look at the 3 red players behind the control of the panic room, that high ground. Walkie is just mincing them up with this minigun here. FD going to claim the frag onto Bohawk, and Depths is just being kept as a pet now and last. Oh, Walkie's gonna run out and kill him, padding his stats there with a cheap medic frag.
That's the situation where you gotta leave the medic alive, because if he's just gonna stand and taunt instead of kill bind,
then he's gonna backcap you.
Well, no, ignore that. Like, you gained a massive Uber advantage.
Well, they already have a huge Uber advantage. Costin's gonna be coming forward with this 100%. Depths has not even spawned yet, no heals on the board. And it's all up to early. If they want to make something happen, early running the sniper has a potential to drop Costin, but he's going to try and hold on to that. They get the frag onto Commander Thundercock and Embrace. And now the Uber's just going to be barreled into them early, trying to take this one forwards. Along with Raider, there's a potential for a lot of damage, but they kind of missed their opportunity. Now the Rebels are positioned really far back.
Yeah, there's a fight worth having there, but Commander Thundercock came too early.
Yeah, I mean, he got shafted for sure.
Dude, this is dreadful. This is utterly dreadful. Oh, what an air shot by Paprika! Paprika just slammed Citro main there in the air as he jumps up, and Citro goes for the bomb onto his medic. He defends his medic there with a sick air shot. Well played by Paprika once again. Why is Zebesai fake nicking as Paprika and Lupus is fake nicking as Thundercock? It's a mystery in this tier2pickup.net open rumble, but these two teams cannot be separated at all at the moment. 3-3 the score, and the Rebels are just retaking control of mid, but Ubers up for both teams and only 2.5 minutes left. It's getting down to the crunch time.
3-3. Fight on middle. Both teams with 100%. It could go either way right now. Early picking up the sniper. Oh no, I was going to say he's made the big plays, but that was actually Erhany from the previous game. But look, and what's his angle at the moment? He's still in the sewers trying to get that snipe, but Kostin's positioned really well. I actually like his positioning here. He's just sat in PC. He's completely safe from things, but Raider isn't. He's going to get destroyed back there on the balcony position. This is surely going to prompt the push in from Embrace, but nah, they're just playing it slow. I don't agree with this. You can definitely get away with the Denmark Sticky Spear around, definitely through PC. There's going to be nothing to inhibit them there, and they're actually going to get launched forward, but Citramain is going to be on the front line. He's going to get the force out. Kostin is still kiting though, but there's Thundercox in the middle of him. He's forced the Uber single-handedly. Really nice play there from the scout. Bohawk's going to have to jump out of this. They're just running away with a tail between their legs at the moment. That soldier gets locked sky high. He's going to get taken out eventually, surely. Surely Embrace is still up though. Embrace hiding in sewers, but it's still 5 up. Only Citramain went down in that
Raider. Yeah, Raider actually getting juggled away there by some stickies, dies to the fall damage. And the Rebels are going to be trying to hold on to this early, taking a shot. But he's not going to quite manage it, a little too late there, which is a bit ironic. But the rest of his team going to be backing out through the choke point. Both demos down and Uber's equal. But with 1 minute remaining, it's on Citramine's care package to really push this one forwards. It's going to be difficult to reverse the tide of the battle and get around within the 57 seconds left. So for the Rebels, it really is just sit back and defend and really try and turtle out the next 50 seconds. But for Citramine and the rest of their Mike care package crew, they need to be pushing this one forwards. The time is ticking.
Imagine how great the legacy would be there. You've got the TCM on Gullywash, which is the, 50 second comeback. What if the Thundercock on Process is the same? What a legacy that would be. But it is going to be the Uber coming in now, which will win or lose this fight. Jeff gets launched up. He doesn't have Uber yet. He will go down. And this is surely going to be the last point. There's only Citramine who is actually down. And there's a couple of people behind Thundercock and Paprika. They're just... Oh, they can block it, though. They can block the second point. Can Thundercock do it? This is massive. The rest of the... Oh, he doesn't manage it. This is going to be it.
Citramine, Smike, care package. Take the map 4-3 with only 10 seconds left on the clock. They will be progressing to the finals along with one of the teams from Millennium Legends versus the Chaotic Pups. Oh, the Chaotic Pups actually destroyed that one 5-0. So Chaotic Pups, the team that we saw with that incredibly close game just before this one on CP Sunshine, are going to be taking on Citramine's Mike care package in the grand finale of our TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble number one.
I can't believe what a throw that was. That was like both teams were just playing for the golden cap or something. Maybe Jebs took his eye off the ball a little bit, didn't build that Uber fast enough, but it was like a neck and neck Uber race. I cannot believe he didn't get that charge up, and they just seemed to throw that one, an absolute throw. There will be no professional killstreak kits, specialized killstreak kits, or standard killstreak kits, or serve me subscriptions available to them. They are out of the tournament sideshow.
They are indeed. They have been kicked out of here, and we are going into our final, which is a best of three situation.
What? There's first, second, and third place, surely, though. So how does the third place get decided?
Oh, that's a very interesting question.
Thanks, bro. I want to see this killstreak kit on Thundercock.
I have no idea how that gets decided, actually. We'll have to talk to Buttnose, who's organising the tournament. There needs to be some kind of consolation match.
Yeah, if you look at the same time. If you look on the brackets, it looks like there's two matches in round four, which I imagine is the final and the third place match.
Well, there we go then. The dream still has a chance. The dream is still alive. There is a consolation final to decide who comes third there. That'll be between Millennium Legends and the Rebels. But given how strong the Rebels look in that game, just throwing it at the last moment, and the fact that Millennium Legends got 5-0'd by the other grand finalists, Chaotic Pups, I think the Rebels will be feeling good about their chances going into that consolation final. But we're not going to be covering that. We're not covering the scrub game of the two. We're going to be covering the grand finals, which is a best of three. How are the maps decided? Are they set?
I think they're set, bro. I'll tell you the order right now. First game, we are going to have Gullywash. Second map is going to be Badlands. And third is going to be Koth Viaduct.
Interesting. So if we make it onto Viaduct, that's going to be an intense final map. But do you think Chaotic Pups, they had a pretty easy semi-final there, winning that one 5-0. But the previous match that they played, against Peraspera Ad Astra was really quite close, 3-2 on Sunshine. They might not be looking so good here against the unstoppable force of Citroën's Might Care Package.
Well, I'm not so unstoppable. That last game went down to the wire, and we've seen both of these teams like fight in tense situations, so hopefully we'll have some good games over the three and maybe even a golden cap. Like so far I think a lot of teams have just been excellent at pushing through to the finals, and we often see that like stalemates are happening in the middle of the map, and like either we see like a complete wipe and a team taking a final point, or the attacking team gets completely destroyed and we have a fight all the way back to middle. Like these are very really one-way fights, and I think it makes for much more of an enjoyable game.
Yeah. Teams really committing in with all they've got, maybe not quite learned yet to not put all their eggs in one basket, but it really lends itself to some great spectator great spectator TF2 as they just throw themselves in.
They really seem to favor waiting for that Uber charge as well, even if it means it's going to be like a Uber versus Uber fight. They seem to like that, you know, safety net of the charge. But there's definitely a lot of opportunities here for these open teams to up their game. You know, look at that scoreboard. Any man advantage is worth playing off, in my opinion. I want to see them elevating their game here as we move into this grand final. I think we will be, then after the final, we will be jumping into the Gaming Grids tournament. But it looks like the schedule for that has actually gone back another hour, so there could even be a break in between. That would be nice.
I think we'll have a short break now as well, because the grand final is scheduled for 15 minutes time, unless you have any pressing issues that you can discuss about that. But the first map, CP Gullywash, is going to be going live in 15 minutes here between Chaotic Pups and Citromine's Mike Care Package.
And Maribor, do you want to give us those 15 minutes?
I think actually Butno says I'm going to move this game forward so things don't take so long. So
you little shit.
our break has been ripped out from right underneath us.
I was going to say, Maribu, do you have any more puns that you didn't manage to squeeze into that last game?
Oh, mate, I was just looking for the right opportunity there to whip out a few more, but I think Saicho, he was on top of things. You know, Balls Deep was definitely the slam dunk. That was the pinnacle, for me anyway.
Like creme de la creme.
I like the fact that we both waited for him to die, and then I said he came in too early, and you said he got shafted within about 5 seconds. I was happy with that.
Oh, really, my god. He was just, you know, he was all over the place, man. But right at the end, you know, even though his team failed and they all died, Commander Thundercock stood tall and proud. He was the last man alive there, but that's the end of his journey in this cup, at least probably we're going to cast anyway. You do say there is a bronze match there. He could still get himself a nice killstreak kit. But again, shout out to our title sponsor, tf2pickup.net. I see they have a blog post up there. I pasted it in chat earlier. Maybe I can send it in there again. But they're talking about their new design and, as you say, taking over North America. Got their eyes on the prize. Can they compete with ESEA, Saito? Does anyone play those pugs?
I don't think anyone. Well, I think occasionally some of the higher level players, when they stream, particularly Banny, I think attempt to get the ESEA pugs going, but I think it's a bit of a convoluted system that nobody particularly uses that much. But I think the biggest competition will be tf2pug.me, which is a kind of captain system, a little bit like that, but the infrastructure around tf2pickup.net perhaps slightly superior. It'll be interesting to see how they fare, but it's a very good system. I keep getting banned from there repeatedly, so I really shouldn't be promoting them. But
why is that?
I really like to test new unlocks and test different strategies. And the tf2pickup.net admins, they don't like the way that I test strategies.
Weirdly, like, people see that as you throwing games. Like, I can't believe that. Like,
yeah,
it's ridiculous, right?
I'm just trying to revolutionize the metagame, and these people are getting annoyed at me playing full-time spy or full-time pirate.
What does a man have to do?
So unfair.
You have to get, like, the important thing, I think, is to get buy-in from your team. I played a couple of games yesterday, like, for the first time in a long time, and I hadn't played with the Vaccinator since the Gunmetal update, and I know I had a lot of changes, so, you know, have to give them, you know, the a bit of politic, and you have to sell it to them nicely. Okay, guys, we're going to be running the vaccinator here for the next 30 minutes. Don't get mad. Just try and make it work. But then you have a dribbler like Koth just running, you know, Huntsman Sniper all the time. We can only change so many variables at one side, Joe. But I definitely appreciate the fact that TF2Pickup.net have jumped in with the early adoption of the Primzilla's new super official whitelist.
It is actually super official now, though. It's has posted an ETF2World thread about it and all that jazz, which is if you want to check out the new or the test whitelist for season 22, which is going to be starting within the month, then check out whitelist.tf/4432. And we read it out a little bit earlier, so it'll be interesting to see how those games go down. I think that the TF2 pickup itself is an interesting way to check out the unlocks, but a lot of people just want to mess about with them in a pickup situation. If you try it out in your scrims, though, as you work up towards season 22, it'll give some valuable feedback.
I can't wait for season 22. It's going to be at least another 2 weeks before we start seeing that Prem qualifier action. But as we said, so many things happen between now and then. And like, we've got at least 2 cups a week now, courtesy of Gaming Grids, the developers behind the Razer Arena system. They've been throwing out $100 bi-weekly. In fact, you know, 4 times a week, because they do it EU and NA. We might try and cast one of their cups after this, well, after a break and later on this evening. But there is plenty more TF2 action, not just today, but throughout the month of September. It's going to be chock-a-block. Is that the STV you just posted there, Saito?
It is indeed. The teams have started joining the server now.
Baby.
For our grand final of the TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble. Are you ready to rumble?
I am.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Excellent. Okay, so we can begin. As soon as these teams get all 12 players onto the server and ready themselves up, the first map is going to be Gullywash. That's how we're going to start the proceedings tonight. But it's going to be Chaotic Pups against Citramine's Might Care Package. And both of these teams we've seen before in this tournament. I'm favouring Citramine's Might Care Package for this.
I'm all about the Chaotic Pups. You know, carry on that great DangerDogs.tf legacy. I'm still reeling from their shock LAN garbage gamer performance. So I hope that Chaotic Pups can, you know, keep that canine legacy going.
I haven't made my mind up yet. I'm going to wait.
You're going to wait until the end? Until it's patently obvious who's going to win, and then you're just going to storm in there with your prediction. I'm not quite sure that's how it works, but we'll give you that one.
Even with 2 minutes to go, that last game, you would it was unclear who would win with 2 minutes to go, and you'd be afraid to bet against Commander Thundercock, so I think that last game could have gone either way, so I think I'm well within my rights to keep the broadcasters neutral, with the fact that we don't have a majority vote.
Absolutely.
I think it's going to be a golden cap. There we go.
A golden cap, yep. And Butners is telling me to mention as well that there is going to be an upcoming mid-cup. So in the same way that this was the TF2 Pickup Open Rumble, there's going to be a TF2, or potentially a different sponsor, but there's going to be a mid Rumble as well, which is going to be in about 2 weeks' time. So all of you guys who weren't able to sign up to this cup because you were slightly too experienced and have a team in mid, you guys can play in that one. And
are you going to play or cast that one, Saito?
I think of the three of us, Ali can actually play in that one.
Don't be mean, guys. Yeah, I can. I will be. Someone pick me up, please.
And that'll be a juicy 20 keys up for grabs by serveme.tf. So nice stuff by them. There'll be some juicy goodies for you to win if you want to sign up for that cup, if you want to get some experience just before season 22 starts, see where you compare to the rest of the teams in or around a mid-level. If you are an open team and you want to profess to the league admins of Permzilla and Sunny Black, if they put you in open and you guys think you should be a mid, sign up to that cup, get some experience, show them what you can do, and I'm sure they'll seed you somewhere more fair
or perhaps not. Sonny Black is enjoying a holiday in Canada, and he's left ETF2L in the hands of the TF2 Slayer Permzilla himself. So who knows what they'll do? They'll probably seed all the Prem teams in Open.
It's probably the last season of ETF2L ever, now that Permzilla's at the helm. But enjoy it when you can, guys. And everybody get ready to switch over to Overwatch for all that sweet, sweet Blizzard esports money.
Or not.
Or not. Maybe like a game that requires skill and, you know,
a little, I like to be able to aim mechanical and move movement in my game. And not just press one button to rocket jump.
There are times when I wish I had auto aim in TF2. That's probably why I play medic, but
yeah, you've essentially got a trigger bot on your weapon. You'd have to aim at people to heal them.
And still I drop people, I don't know. I don't know, man, it's tough.
We're gearing up for our first map here. It's going to be CP Gullywatch. There are 11 players on the server. We're just waiting for one more from Chaotic Pups. I'll be blowed if I can remember who it is from the last time we cast them. Autin's scout partner, that's who we're waiting for. But as soon as he trickles onto the server, we'll be getting ready to play some video games, or at least cast some video games, watch some video games, as the two best teams in the TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble start things off.
Is Raider someone different from Raider?
Yeah.
Because he is definitely too good for this. Just wanted to confirm that after casting, I don't know, 20 of their games. But yeah, I'm still all about the Chaotic Pop side, so I don't know what you see in Saruman's main care package.
Yeah, I just think they're going to blast it. Like, they won the previous game. And
did they win it 5-0?
Yeah, but the Chaotic Pups obviously just had a really easy semi-final if they managed to win it 5-0.
I think you are sleep deprived. You spent too long streaming and playing PUBG last night, struggling to get a win, and now you're just, you don't even know what a winner looks like anymore if you're back in Sitraman's mic care package. Like, this is going to be an easy 2 maps, 5-0, 5-0.
We'll see how it plays out as Lindskog has actually joined the server. I'm sure that wasn't the scout they were using before, but never mind, the super sub has come. Maybe that's what's made the previous one a 5-0, but we are live with our first mid alley.
Oh, baby. I'm so excited. I just can't hide it. I'm ready for this rumble in the jungle to hit its final conclusion. Maybe if we get 2 maps, we'll be able to go back to watch that third place. I don't know if that's best of 3. But either way, we are going to start off on this Gullywash middle. Team's playing a bit passively so far, no one gone for the big jump. It's actually Feeder who makes the first initiative onto the demo man. He's going to get completely closed down as the entirety of the Pups team come up to that side. They are going to have 2 frags. Citramine takes them himself to make the plays, but the medic stays with full health there, nothing being done. And I'm sorry, Sideshow, but Admirable looks like he's going to school you in this vote.
I am the master of the open predictions. Certain man did make a valiant play there. He jumped in so that his medic could escape, but they weren't going to get much done. It will be Uber versus Uber on last, 6 players up on both sides, so we're going to see a classic attack versus defense set piece here. And I like the fact that Certain Man's mic care package are opting to play the cookie cutter setup here. They don't have any gimmick classes. They're ready to just fend off this Uber. They're going to brush it off and they're going to push immediately. They just need to be careful though, because here comes an Ubered scout. He's gonna rush the point. There's stickies on the rim. They're both scouts go down to Raiders sticky trap. Raiders sticky trap. Citraman finds a pick onto Hensi as well. And this is just a defensive masterclass right here, Saito.
It absolutely is. The snow and Mr. Will, the snow. I don't know why I'm calling him the snow. There are plenty of snows. But Snow and Mr. Will are escaping through that choke point, trying to stay attached to as much Uber as they possibly can, but there is a slight advantage here for Koston, and they are pushing out with the pyro as well. Walkie running that full-time pyro. I'm absolutely loving this. Let's see what he can do. Is he going to try and destroy the gunboat's roamer on the flank? Come on, Walkie, big plays.
He's not being met with any fortune right now, just 2 scouts trying to shoot him down. He actually managed to get a flare gun off there, but completely uninsightful point of interest there, just trying to make it seem more interesting. And it just looks like they're gonna have to sit on this flank, because they can't make any big plays on that right hand side with the pyro. There's no way he can make up the ground as quickly as a scout or soldier could, so I'm not really sure what their thinking is in terms of this push.
There's no vision here, you know, like that. He's just standing there on the flank with the pyro, but he could be using that to force his way in through choke before the Ubers had come up. Like, How can you even spam a tilt if there's just a pyro there reflecting all your rockets? That could have been easy entry to middle, but they've decided to wait, and again, they just seem to favor waiting for those uber charges. They don't want to do anything without it. They don't want to make any big commitments unless they have, like, you know, six players down on the opposite side or an uber charge.
They're prodding through the big door. They're trying to get something done. Orton's really weak as well. Got caught by a lot of spam, but it looks like that he's just going to be barreling in. Raiden is forced to take that uber charge in the choke area, and he's actually pinning them in a little bit, but it's a much better uber here from the Chaotic Pups team. They managed to get a lot of position. Walkie is going to go down along with Costin. They've lost two, but that pick on the medic is going to be crucial, I think. And they keep overextending away from these heals, though. They have that heal advantage. Snow and Lindos pairing up with Mr. Will. They might be able to clean all of this up here, but Feedid's definitely going to try and make something happen. Raider, with his pipes loaded, going to be trying to spit some out and catch Snow. Oh,
Lindskog on the 5k. Abused that high ground, killed everyone that jumped at him, and kept his medic alive there then with the cleanup frags there, given plenty of time.
CMCP had the player advantage there on the point, and they were stuck at the back of the point, Chaotic Pups, but all they needed to do was heal up their soldiers and jump them at the same time, but they just reeled them off the Lindskog on low health, and he just plucked them out of the air really nicely. So now they're going to have not only the second point, but also a 30% advantage coming into the second point. They're going to rely back on their scouts to do the work, and Costin instantly goes down. There's a couple of players spread around the point. They haven't actually got the most amount of time on there. The stickies are eventually going to get cleared, and it is going to be Orton who stays in there to cap it, and it's going to be 1-0 to Admirable.
1-0 to Admirable?
Yep.
Chaotic Potatoes. We're doing it. 25 minutes, 30 seconds left on the clock. That was a good value round right there, but Sitraman's looking to move up the right hand side here with the aggressive play. The scouts are trying to create the space. He pushed Mr. Will back into the elbow. He's managed to survive. He meets up with Stu, and the first two frags go against Sitraman's Mike Carrot package. Oh, they're just absolutely falling apart here. It's only Raider left alive. A complete wipe comes in. Huge plays. The momentum firmly in favor of Chaotic Pups.
I think Chaotic Pups will win.
It is a best of three, though. Maybe
he spits his prediction as soon as they.
I'm kidding. They're looking in a good position. I'm all about the underdogs here.
The underdogs.
What? Why is that funny?
Chaotic Pups.
Oh, fuck. If anyone made that deliberately.
The accidental pun. Oh, God. We're doing it again, guys. Right, okay, and the Uber is coming in from the top right. It's a double scout Uber, but they're still taking a long time to take down Walkie. And FD on the floor is going to be trying to put down as much damage as he can on these people who play in the point now. Combining with Citramine, they've done a lot of damage, but they need to clean up these frags. Oh, H and Hensi going huge there on the point. The soldiers, buffed after all of that, are just going to be able to clean up everybody from CMCP. And that is 2-0. 24 minutes remaining, still tons and tons and tons of time for things to go, for things to completely flip around here. But for now, they need to be winning the mid-fights. Focus on the mid-fights.
Sitraman skip jumps under and he's managed to contest Hensi here, but both soldiers kind of weak right now, but a big arrow into Sitraman means he's going to be able to win that fight. FD's already gone down though, so he's flying solo as soldier here for Sitraman's mic care package. He's jumped up, he's found a crowd of blue players here, but as the last man alive,
another white.
It doesn't even matter.
This is brutal. It was only FD who died at the start there, and the rest of them all died within the same spawning wave, so they're all going to be coming up now. But I think in future mid fights, we could see sort of Will moving on, trying to get the sort of Kader style spawn camp going. These middles keep playing out the same way.
He's back on his main class pyro, but he's gone down instantly. Uber with the entire team from the shutter door. Yields two frags to pressure the point at the same time. FD's forced to try and contest Orson there, but H is coming in on his back. Only Faded and Sitraman remain alive right now. Sitraman juking around here trying to survive, but will catch a rocket after the fact as Chaotic Pups storm ahead into a 3-0 lead here, guys.
This is disastrous.
Really need to compose themselves right now, otherwise this is shaping up to be the quickest game we've seen so far today, like including those first two games.
Yeah, absolutely. There's still 23 minutes. They've played less than 8 minutes here, and Hensi takes a little bit of damage underneath, but they need to make sure that this mid-fight goes far better for them. Lots of weak players, but they have managed to pick up the carry scout and the demon man here for
the dogs. Oh, big shots there from Citramind and H, who collide in midair. He comes back up.
What's the drop down? Citramind
blows himself up onto Snow. Snow's going to be able to get the health kit and escape as well. Oh, that's disastrous there.
And type in the process as well. Oh, that was such a completely one fight for CMCP. Citramind types in chat, why would you even be there?
How dare you be there on a silver platter medic? What were you thinking? Oh my god. Citramind, like, he is definitely the guy on medals. He has, over the previous fixtures, like, he's been making those openings, but the first couple he didn't have much of an impact, but right there, Citramind delivered for his team. Sure, he killed himself and missed the medic pick, but he single-handedly opened up that middle for him.
And looks like they're just spamming so much damage down here, Celtic Pups, but Citramind are just going to walk all the way through lower. There's going to be a scout Orton now onto Corsten. He actually does get the force. That's really nice there. And so this is going to be quite a difficult position, but Celtic Pups can definitely kite the Zuba. And already it's completely run out for Citramind. And Citramind does come in now himself, but the Zuba is still on and it's going to get completely destroyed.
Citramind!
Three air shots go wide, but they do take him down. And now it looks like the Celtic Pups, just, they didn't lose anyone, and they're going to be able to push him for his mid easy peasy, despite being having been completely flanked in that initial fight.
Raider's been caught out a little bit here, though, as Age manages to find that frag. And they might want to roll this one forwards. Without the Demon Man, those chokes are going to not be locked off very well. They're going to be able to pick up the mid fight here fairly easily. But I want to see them barrel through. I want to see them make use of the fact that they got that Demon Man pick. But I think if Admirable's predictions are correct, they'll just sit back and wait for the Ubers.
What I'm completely confused by there is the fact that Costin survived, because you saw when that Uber was caught him up top and behind. Did he run all the way back through lobby and out lower? Because they're an even percentage at the moment.
Yeah, he survived. The heroic medic escape there from Costin. Citramind was hiding above big door there, manages to get the pick onto Orton. So now they're walking in, but Hensi is standing on that ledge, manages to trade there with FD. And the slow push continues to inch its way across the point here. And oh wow, it seems like Celtic Pups don't know what to do. They've already dropped one player, their superstar scout Linskog, gone down as the Ubers have been traded. Celtic Pups, time to tuck tail, they're backing off here, but they do have one man trapped behind enemy lines. It's Orton versus Wonky. The pistol too strong there from Orton. He's going to pick up the kit. And he's being contested now by Feed It and FD, so he's distracted two players here. That's, you know, a relative man advantage here for Celtic Pups, and hence he's going to start moving forward. Maybe if the rest of his team push, they could get a favourable engagement. Orton has just been left, actually decided to ignore him, they're not even going to contest him.
Yeah, it's a bit awkward here for Chaotic Pups because they've got the Uber advantage, but they don't have six players to push. So it does look like Orton's found himself all the way back behind. He's actually found himself on the medic.
What?
The medic, oh my, he can't have done that. That's ridiculous.
Oh my god.
He's still in, actually. He's gone back down, dropped out, so he's still in this mid-fight.
He's still in. He got another frag onto the Roma, and he's still bopping around. He's going to come
and up. He's now out of the door.
It's the Orton show here,
FD
folks.
Is behind,
he's just
FD is behind. FD, they haven't seen him yet. They haven't seen him. Oh, he gets exploded, though.
Absolutely destroyed there. With the combined self-damage of his rocket jump and that sticky. Citramind on the respawn though is going to jump in. He needs to save base here. He does get the force out. And he's going to keep his... he's going to keep this a fair fight here. It's going to be no Ubers for either side right now. But the point will change hands. CP4 goes from red to blue. Oh, there's Raider just peeking out with a few stickies. But they just need to buy enough time for these spawns coming. And here they are. It's going to be 6-on-6. A dry push? A non-Uber push? What's going on here, guys?
Oh, Mr. Will 1v1's a heavy with his pipes. He's just going to sit on the side, spamming out damage while the rest of his team pushes the point. Another clinical push from Chaotic Pups. They've managed to fight their way through the tough bit and do what they do best and taking that last point. And 4-0.
Beautiful. Chaotic Pups, they have ascended to the next level. They're not waiting for Uber anymore. They're just going in when they see an advantage. That's what he wants, actually.
It absolutely is. That increases the pace of the game, but Chaotic Pups up 4-0. And there needs to be some kind of reply here. There's plenty of time for it, but they need to change something up. FD and Citro are going to be bombing up onto that point, trying to get a bit of position, but Citro's taking a lot of damage early, and so is Feeded. The first frag is got. Oh, nice shot there. Oh, and that last rocket from H gets 3 kills. Raider, Walkie, and Feeded all in the exact same place, and his rocket gets a triple kill. The soldiers here from Chaotic Pups going ham. Hensi with the airshot med pick, and then H with the triple frag with a single rocket. Unbelievable stuff.
He's hungry for more. He's already taken a peek into main. They have been so aggressive here. They're still 25% of their Uber to build, but they're going to have it momentarily. And it looks Mr. Will's set up a bit of a sticky trap there on the left hand side, an aggressive trap, but the play seems to be scout Uber. Going to be double
Pyro.
Scout here for the roller.
Work.
Ooh, Walkie goes down. Just got a couple of reflects up there, but didn't do much damage. The Sitterman's trying to jump in behind as the blue players move forward, but they've already made it onto the point and they're going to get that cap. Wow. And that was a 5-0. Who would have predicted it?
I don't know. I don't think any of us predicted that, actually. Well, it might have been you. Either way, we're going to see a 5-0 in this first map, Gullywash, hoping CMCP can pull it back on Badlands. But it was a much more dominant display than I think we saw Pups put up earlier in the tournament.
I believe in them. I believe in my boys. Citroën's care package, Mike, crew are going to be able to do this.
Do you think you've got these words a bit in the wrong order?
No. That's their team name. That's their new team name. They just messaged me on Steam. They've just changed it.
CCPM.
So, they lose that first map 5-0. Got absolutely stomped there by the Chaotic Pups. And as we move on to our next map, we'll just be taken out of this STV just for a moment and log back into a different one. And what map are we going to now, Ali?
Going to Badlands, Broski.
Badlands, a classic. Everybody knows Badlands. Everyone knows how to play on Badlands. It's a perfect one for any kind of mixed team or a team with mercs. So are we going to see something closer this time, Admirable?
Nope. It's going to be another 5-0, mate.
Oh, don't do this to me. Don't do this to me. We need to see it go to Viaduct.
You've lined your bets, Sideshow. You've got to stick by them.
I mean, you're clearly coming from within the Sitterman care package camp. What can you tell me about their Badlands game? Do they have the skills to pay the bills?
Absolutely. I mean, this team here is a renowned Badlands team. They've beaten the best on CP Badlands. I saw them take down Froyotech 5-0 earlier today. As they were playing, they were actually playing on a Hawaiian server, so 300 ping, and FD was just hitting the crispest rockets you've ever seen. Everybody was demolished there, so I believe in them on Badlands. It's one of their strongest maps. Gullywash, terrible for them. Terrible map, Gullywash. So when we come onto Badlands, I'm predicting a 5-0 stomp in the other way, and then they're going to take Viaduct as well.
You know, definitely is a case to be made for Sitterman's care package. They do have some redeeming features, and maybe Gullywash was just their boogie map.
Guys, I'm doing something we should have done for quite a while, which is probably look at logs. And for that last game, there's one stat which does definitely stand out, which is the medic Snow and the amount of deaths he had, which is a big fat zero.
Decent.
Zero deaths, bro. Zero deaths.
That's the medic dream, you know, that's what we all aspire for.
Is this guy better than Shade, is the question. Well, no, but I'm trying to create some hypothetical atmosphere.
Is he the best medic on the server? Yes.
Quite possibly. Out of those in Source TV as well? Probably still, yeah.
Have you seen my medic play?
I've heard about it.
We have, yes.
And my reputation precedes me.
Is it, we just reconnect to the same STV, is that how it works?
No, I think they give it a different server. Apparently it might take a few moments just to initialize the new server, and then we will be given the informations. I believe that's what Dilusive tells me, that's how we're going to be working here, so hopefully we can get that sorted fairly shortly with you guys. But do you want to give a shout out to the raffle and the blog and things regarding?
Absolutely. The raffle, which is the last raffle of the stream, the one with all the mad loot for unusuals, 3 keys, an Australian Blutsauger and a pair of earbuds. That's been going on for over an hour now, but it's coming into the final stages now. There must be like 20 minutes or less. Let me type! Raffle.
Yes, I got into the raffle.
In chat.
595 entries so far.
Yeah, only 8 minutes and 56 seconds remaining, so get on board. There's still plenty of room in that raffle, you're right, Ali. Sign up there. But these guys that were at the Gamer Cast, and they don't even need to enter the raffle. They might want to, but they've already guaranteed themselves at least 6 specialized killstreak kits and 2 Serve Me 3-month server subscriptions. That's if they finish second, but if they go all the way, if they go for gold, they will get themselves 6 professional killstreak kits and 3 Serve Me 3-month server subscriptions. And that is courtesy of Ari and Veethoofed. TFTPickup.net, obviously the title sponsor of this Open Rumble being organized on the Razer Arena platform. They've got big plans. They've just put up a blog post there about their plans for world domination, and at the very least a little bit of a site redesign, so any of those features you've been crying out for, they could be coming soon. And of course the incredible, admirable voice pack has still been there since the beginning. I recommend the Pyrovision version. Worthy reason to donate.
They did ask me to do a voice pack for them, and they never put it on. I recorded two separate versions of it, and nary a glimpse of it on the site. It's
I'd use that.
Thank you. It was it's very disheartening. Very disheartening. I think probably because I've been banned so many times. They very much don't want my patronage.
Why do you get banned?
Because I'm testing out the new Season 22 whitelist, which they have just announced. ETF2L, the signups are open for Season 22, and the test whitelist as well has been finalized. So if you guys have teams, if you don't have teams, you should get a team and play in ETF2L Season 22. It's going to be a fantastic season running from late September, probably around the 27th, something like that. Let me see. It is the 27th until November the 12th. So that's running until the end of this calendar year, essentially. And then the playoffs after that is going to be fantastic. The ETFL season is always very well run. If you guys want to play in it, then find a team, sign up for it, and get involved. And have a look at the test whitelist as well. Give some feedback on whether you think those weapons should be allowed or not.
Don't even have a look at it, mate. Head on over to tftpickup.net and play with it. They have it live right now. You can get banned too. You too can join Saito on the Hall of Fame, the ban list. But Saito, I suppose we should appeal to people to have an open mind, because every time unlock's always a contentious issue, and every time new unlocks get added, people are always going to play with them a little bit. Might expect the standard of the game to be a little bit lesser as people try to adapt or just straight up get mad and quit the game. But I'd encourage you to just take a few deep breaths, calm yourself, and think about the bigger picture here. Prepare yourself for Season 22, where those unlocks will be coming at you fully loaded.
Thick and fast. Yeah, it's going to be fantastic. We'll see Rocket Jumper, Mantreds, and the Market Gardener. I mean,
Demo Knights.
Amazing. It's amazing. We're surpassing ESEA in terms of open whitelists, and that's always a good thing. We're leading the charge. The European continent in the lead in terms of most open, most potential to be trolled whitelist.
It's Valve's game, baby. It's Valve's game. We do have 11 on the server, hence they actually in spec as well. People are readying up map 2 of this TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble number 1 grand final. It's going to be getting underway soon.
And I've had potentially the oddest request from a Steam message ever as well. Someone added me randomly and said, "Hey man, can I have a gift from you?"
Has that ever worked before?
I have no idea, but he sent me a trade offer, so we'll see what he wants from me.
Definitely not a scam. Give him whatever he wants, Aicho.
Yeah, I think I will.
Yeah, he'll probably just give it back.
Yeah, I'm sure he will. He just wants to borrow it for a little while.
The sim guy, he's asking for the IP. I don't think he's even on the server, as the game has gone live here, I believe, yet. We
radio.
Are going in hot. Sim is telling us it's all his fault.
He's in, boys. All right. So this is the first minute. Looks like it's going to be... see who's going to take the aggression here. It's going to be a big jump from Hennessy. Tries to go on Cotton. Cotton safely back in house at the moment. Citramine goes high, but just gets destroyed in the air by Skagans. Feed is still under, but he's going to be starting to run out now as the whole of CMCP is caught up in a big choke area there. All weak as well. Cotton on 44 HP does get taken down. Scout and Demo are weak in house. Walkie on 20 HP. He's just going to try and get out. Raider going in for no apparent reason. Trying to get damage, but... Snow is fine on 110, keeping that unkilled streak still running, and Chaotic Dog's keeping up the train from last map straight onto second point.
He is. They are going to be steamrolling this one forwards. They got an opportunity just to make this one 1-0 before 2 minutes have passed. Oh, Citramine trying to get aggressive there onto Snow and pop out the Uber, but Snow is going to hold onto that one. No chance of that happening. That makes it 6v5 as well with the Uber advantage. And where are they gearing up to push from? Looks like a top left, potentially. Are they going to go? They're really tentative for some reason. I'm not sure why. They have that full Uber charge. They need to be going before Citro gets the spawn in order to maximize this pick advantage. Feed goes down, which was the Pyro, and they're playing the point. That's dropped both the soldiers down there. And as Linskog runs on the point, surely this is going to get capped off. This might actually be a defense here. H and Snow. Oh, no. Mr.
Oh, well played, Bottle.
So close, so close.
Never doubt the pups. It may be chaotic, you know. Things might look a little sketchy, but they have a plan, man. That's going to be 1-0. We're going to the second mid here, and from barely 2 minutes played, it's looking good for another 5-0. That's what the people want. They want to see a display of canine excellence. It's going to be a slope rollout here from Snow yet to die. And, oh, I tried to jinx him, but he manages to surf out on 60. It's costing, goes down. Better luck next time, buddy. Let's go, Chaotic Pups. Three players down right now for Citramine's Mic Care package. Uh-oh, it's turned into a 3-on-3 all of a sudden. Mr. Will is struggling to connect the pipe. Snow goes down! The curse
for the
of the caster
time
is real.
since the beginning of the start map, Snow has gone down. And Citramine's... I think they must have won a middle on Gullywash at some point. But either way, I'm guessing Snow must have got out when that happened. But yeah, it's the end of an era. Maybe this is the turning point.
Very potentially, they've managed to find their way onto this mid-fight. Mr. Will and Hensi still both down. Hensi with a really long spawn, so they'll be able to get onto Spire if they just play a bit more aggressively, but they're so passive. They really don't want to take advantage of any momentum. They want to slow the game down. No, now they push. All right, they're just waiting for Chaotic Pups to get into some kind of favorable position, and then they're going to run through the choke point. They're taking so much damage here because they spent so long messing about in the choke, and Ryder's going to go down. Citramine's taking so much damage.
God.
There goes FD. Bad timing there from CMCP, and Chaotic Pup's going to be driving this one forward.
Huge play from H there. He was just dancing around on 100, continually putting out that splash damage. Managed to survive for so long. In fact, the whole duration of the fight, and that was a complete wipe. Raider just respawning right now, and he is in the forward spawn here. He's going to spawn back to last as Demoman. He is like their only hope right now. He needs to go huge here with the clutch defense.
FD stayed out spawned on that second point, and he's going to look for the pick, but he's far too early. He does manage to get the nice jump into Snow, but there's just too many bodies there, and it's going to be a pipe from Will that finishes this off, as we've got another Uber situation coming in this top left. The Pirate is going to be there once again. He survives a bit longer this time, but it still looks like it's going to be an aggressive point. The stickies are dead, but oh, there's Link Dog on there. There's no one there after the stickies to look at the second rush onto the point, and that's really nicely played. The sticky's on point. Just wait for someone to do it, and then a second later, there's going to be nothing there. And man, it's basics.
It is indeed. This is going to be our third mid fight, and Citramine's Mic Care package really need to shake themselves off and approach this one with a new mentality. It looks like they're going up by the closet. Citramine, they're going to bomb in there. Great soldier aggression, linking up with FD perfectly to take down the medic and the demo. Linskog, though, coming in behind, is going to get taken out. And Hensi, the last man alive. Oh, and H there. Oh, unfortunate to lose Costin. But some nice pipes coming out of Raider, and they have won their second mid. So now they just have to stop it going so wrong from this position.
Yeah, I don't know if they've... Because Costin died so late, they definitely can't take the Spire, so there's going to be no risk of what happened last time, where they should have pushed, but then didn't push, and like they should definitely stick with this position on middle, especially if they've got the Uber disadvantage now. So, yeah, I'm looking to see some forward stickies and just hanging out on their train. baiting the aggression.
Kostin's
mad. You know the deal.
He spawned with crits. It's going to be pretty much neck and neck if both teams build their charge here, but it seems like Walking doing a good job of administering that self-damage. Ency, actually, the Blue Roamer here, taking a little peek from the balcony. You might have seen that crits. He's putting out a little spam there. He's getting a feel for things. But the crits is just edging forward here. A 2% lead being... it's growing greater and greater now. If they push, like,
need to be
right
forward.
On the dot, they could go forward. Huge. They haven't done it.
They need to be there now. It's going to be too late.
Comes in. Snow's still on full health, though. Here comes the crits. He got them. Crits play goes huge. Superman's mic care package. They've tried to take Marit into their own hands. It worked momentarily, but then the double soldier wombo combo of Hitch and Hensi, they just clutched it.
I believe. Kostin.
Gets the trade. You'll be happy with that.
H did so much work there, though. When the crits came in, he wasn't one of the casualties and was able to pump out so much damage on those crits players. Even when they found that frag onto Snow right at the beginning and dropped his Uber, it's still a failure. Just the raw DM talent shining out from Chaotic Pups.
And it's an advantage here for Chaotic Pups. They have 50% in the tank already as Kostin begins to build. He's not on crits anymore. Sidraman trying to jump in there. Does manage to put out damage to HFD, claims the frag from long range, but they're happy enough to continue here with 5-on-5. They're almost at the Uber charge. They're kind of putting the brakes on a little bit here. They want to make sure they get that charge, I guess, but Mr. Will is all alone on the right. He's getting rushed now by Walking, but he's two big pipes and Walking packing. And we already have Linskog on the point. He's going to drop off to contest feed. He wants to make sure his medic survive. And they still have this huge Uber advantage. It is slowly dwindling now that they've hit that full 100%, but they can still push.
Just completely behind the point, 70 HP, not really going to get anywhere. I think he was trying to look for a med play, but just gets completely destroyed. And now, despite the Uber advantage, it's going to be a little bit harder for Chaotic Dogs to work with something. They are definitely going to use this, though. Definitely the right choice to go in with those two scouts, try and get something. Raider's caught out of position here, and the scout's just going to run on the point. Raider down, so there's no sticks. Soldiers have to drop there, so it's just going to be a complete cluster on the point. As there's got that soldier up top, H. If he can get enough spam damage down, they can definitely do this. It's that soldier up in the air, he runs up the point, he gets it!
Juggles a soldier up with one rocket, plucks him out of the air with the other. Sitramand is schooled there by H. He's just having the game of his life here on Badlands. Sideshow, could we see this guy at I-58?
I think we'll see this entire team at I-58. Chaotic Pups for I-58. Champions, they are looking fantastic here coming forwards. 3-0, we're onto our fourth mid. Hensi's playing around that closet area. He's going to bomb around at the same time as H does. They're trying to get a lot of damage out. They do manage to find Feed and Raider there. Citro's going to bomb in and attempt to get something else. A really nice rocket to take down Snow. But that is too little, too late. It's just going to save the Uber situation. Potentially, H is actually trying to get onto Kostin, making him go backwards there, so that's going to delay it.
Linkstalk is here. There's no way Kostin's getting out here, surely. And he goes down in the end. It's worse in that situation. If you see the scout coming, you just want to press K and die as quickly as you can. But now, I mean, Snow did go down, but there's not going to be any heals for 10 seconds, so definitely Spire and potentially a free push into last. Actually, no, 5 seconds. That'll
I got
right.
A question. Are you allowed to pick up medi guns in this cup? I didn't.
No, it's banned.
It's allowed in the other cups, though, isn't it?
No, it's now banned in the other cups as well. It was previously allowed in the Fragfest, but they banned it as of yesterday.
How come?
Because it is a broken.
Seems logical to ban it then.
That's how we roll. Don't like that shit? Ban it. Then petition Primzilla to unban everything. Let's go, no whitelist, season 22. You know what makes sense, Primzilla. Double soldier spam coming in bottom right here. As H and Hensi try to catch somebody out there. Classic Epsilon maneuver, but doesn't yield a frag. They're going to have to regroup and look for another way to break this defense. They might have heard Walker call out there that he is playing Pyro with that medic call, but that is definitely something they have to watch out for. That can totally nullify your Uber. H is trying to peek in here, but Walking playing the Pyro has moved back out because he's not going to be able to stuff them back in the door, but he will be able to reflect some projectiles. An immediate counter pop coming in here. They could have probably milked that a little bit, but they Oh, they're going to send FD forward. He's got a few seconds. Remember, he's not sure who to shoot at, though. He's got HN to 25, but nobody follows up. One scout running in there. Could have got a couple of frags, but it's actually Sitterman going down that seems to put the brakes on here. Uh-oh, Woggy as well. It's now 4 versus 6. The defenders are crumbling. Only 3 alive right now. There's already Sticky's being put on the point. Mr. Will's going to jump forward. He's sticking himself
damage.
He's what? He doesn't cut level hairs away. Oh, and since he's going to step on there and claim the round.
That was completely lost from the moment that Mr. Will just jumps on the point, but Raider just didn't have enough stickies there, and Will was only just put down to 30 HP, so Raider had to drop to the point to try and actually get the kill, and from that position he was just completely screwed from just sort of area denial from that point onwards. So, oh, this is looking like it, boys. Could this be the last round? We need TMCP to make a mark. What are you seeing, Sideshow?
I am watching as they attempt to push in. But they're just finding all the picks everywhere. NC takes a decent pipe, but Raider's cut out in a really bad position. The Chaotic Pups have got all the position on the point here, though, and they're just raining down damage onto everybody. Kostin is attempting to escape. He is going to be able to get out into lower lobby. And as Mr. Will floods forward with the rest of the team, as the Ubers are equal as well, I'm sure they'll be able to take upper lobby control and consider pushing this. But this time, Uber v Uber. Oh, here we go, the FD looking like he wanted to get forwards. Just peeking, actually, just getting some information, seeing where they're coming at. But they're going to be pushing into a sentry as well. The engineer building up on the top right-hand side. How are they going to trade these Ubers?
This is where it starts, boys. You've got to believe. Halo believe. This is going to be the comeback. This is where it starts right now. They've given up the pyro defense against Uber, and they've taken an Uber defense against Uber. Definitely the right strategy. The Ubers are finally going to wear out in this middle area. FD looking for something, but scared of overextending right here. He's against a scout and a soldier. He's done really well, though, but he's not got any frags. Raider has finally had to back him up. Does get the kill onto Linkdog. Coming forward now with that loose cannon, and Walkie's there to pick up the kills. Hensi is looking for the bottom right play, though. He's got a sentry that he's no way going to get past. If he can sneak onto the point, then he might be all right. He's met a scout, though, and Feed is surely not going to let him get. He's stuck behind the point now, hence he's surely going to go down. If we turn our attention back, H has picked up a double kill. FD is...
Hensi!
Oh, just my God.
Blasting the defense. Like, we managed to set a nice little air shot there onto Raider that didn't kill him, but then Ordson comes in and claims that frag, just steps on the point, and that is it. Done and dusted, these pups. Oh, my God. 5-0, 5-0. I was kind of joking when I said that, but...
They heard you, boy. They heard you.
Sideshow, you licking your wounds there, buddy?
I'm devastated. Absolutely devastated. The Chaotic Pups. So good. So good. Absolutely undeniable skill. And that's... they are the victors of the TF2Pickup.net Open Rumble. And they get 6 professional Killstreak kits, 3 serveme.tf 3-month server subscriptions, and they knock down Citramine's mic care package into the second place. Who came third as well? Where's that gone? Let's see if we can find out that information. The third place match still actually going on there between Millennium Lego something and Rebels, but we're not interested in those guys. We're not interested in who came third and fourth. We were on about who were the victors of the tournament, and that title went to the Chaotic Pups.
I think so the people do want to know, though, if Commander Thundercock has got himself a...
Oh, that's a good point, actually.
Got himself a kill streak.
How is Commander Thundercock done?
Have you got the IP?
Let's have a look, actually. The match does say that it's live. Let's see where they're up to. And it's just loading things. Oh, they're actually they're still having issues with the server, actually.
6-3 was the first map score, I think. 2 actually Millennium Legends, I think. So we're just moving on to they're just moving on to Badlands right now.
They are indeed, yeah, they're moving on to Badlands. They're still having a bit of difficulty with that. 6-3. Should we grace them with our presence, Admirable, or should we tie things off here and just crown the victors?
Saito, I think you want us to stop this cast, so I'm going to say, keep going! We're going to cast the bronze match.
Yay! Let's do it!
I just want to mention that big-ass raffle did end. I scrolled up here through Twitch chat, and I can tell you the winners were DDF5 Fate at I-55, TLAG11, Star Cheeseburger, NQ Yamagi Hyper, Manic, Ramco, Laxi, Alloy22, and Frodo Fosbo. Congratulations to all those guys. Head over to scrap.tf raffles to collect your winnings. That's the last raffle for the stream, though, I believe.
I'm distraught. My first raffle didn't win anything.
The fans demand Thundercock, Sideshow. It would be rude. It would be rude not to jump into this game.
Let's do it then. Let's jump into the Thundercock game.
What is the STV IP?
I'll grab it for you right now. I think they're still having a few difficulties with the server, so we might be delayed a little while, but yeah, there's the information for you.
Thanks, bro.
You know, Sideshow, if you want to take a break, that's fine. You know, if you can't continue.
No, I'm ready for the Thundercock. That sentence has been said far too many times by me. Right, let's get things going. I've just relaunched my TF2 after it crashed previously. So we're into the second map of Millennium Legends versus the Rebels. So, yeah, as you say, the CP Gullywash final went 6-3 in favor of Millennium Legends, and now we're just waiting for Badlands to go down. Millennium Legends got 5-0'd by whatchamacallem? Goodness me, what they call Chaotic Pups, who just seem to be a level above everybody else in this tournament. Mm. But that game was probably pretty tight then, 6-3. Pretty tight for the Thundercock.
We have actually another cup coming up after this one. It'll probably be a break in between, guys. But there was just a rush of signups there right at the end, so teams competing in the gaming grid. Fragfest EU number 11, or 12 even, include a mix that features Kratos, Bash, Zub, Captain, Atomic, and F2, as well as the Russian team MSH plus 6. It's, you know, got people like Forsaken, Nookie, Shadowburn, Death.
MSH Kenzie. Plus 6? So just the 6 then. They'll just kick MSH.
MSH isn't in it. But there's also that new Polish super team, Funk Cubed. We've got Hugs.tf. Alright, so they're not worth talking about. Sorry, Hugs.tf. There is a team here called Dicks, which I'd like to cast. Clearly, you know, riding on the Thundercock hype wave. There's a decent German team as well. Nesh, Solid Feeling, Kerry, Raptor. Oh, a decent team of Raptor in it. That is an oxymoron. But yeah. The cup is shaping up nicely. Oh, there's one with Mike as well. Gross Vash of Volant, Nico, Koss, Salentes, Mike, Nation, and Halo. There are some contenders in this cup. That's all I'm saying, Sager.
There definitely are. That's going to be an interesting one. I don't know how this... some of those teams are so weird.
We love Chrissy, Costanza, Starkey, Hairpy, Kiedis, E-Thug, Tiger, Serotonin, Ampus? Is that Amps?
Or yeah,
is that
that's Ampus.
Right, yeah. There we go. Boom.
Yeah, there's a lot of decent teams in there, but they're all kind of mixed teams, so I don't know who's going to come out on top of this one. It's going to be interesting. We're going to have to see. But, yeah, we'll be covering that one after we finish here with the TF2 Pickup Open Rumble. This is our bronze match game to find out whether Commander Thundercock and the Rebel Army have bagged themselves some Killstreak kits.
Indeed.
I reckon we could redo the entirety of Star Wars and just replace the main character with Commander Thundercock leading the Rebel Army, and it would be so much better. It'd be such an improvement, certainly over the prequels.
I think we shouldn't. Well, you know, I'm just worried about the lawsuit. You know, the new Star Wars movies coming out. I'm sure their legal team is on high alert.
I'm sure they're watching, in fact.
JJ Abrams is a big TF2 fan. But I do want to spam this blog link in the chat again. Well, I don't really, because I've been doing it all day. But that little bitch Raptor is messaging me, nagging me to promote their new blog post for their outline and their schemes for world domination. And a few work in progress screenshots there. Of the new look, TF2Pickup.net. They are the title sponsors, so I guess we have to humour him. Who would give Raptor a position of power, Sideshow? I don't understand.
A fool would give Raptor a position of power. But I think his position of power is just to try and market the blog as much as possible. He's added it like a signature to the end of all of his forum posts. And he's,
hey, blog!
Hey, blog! Yeah, so... yeah,
I've heard that said in so long.
Screenshots of the new TF2 Pickup.net design, which is incredibly bright and colourful. and notes in their blog about how they're going to move forwards and capture the world.
I just want to mention as well, like, we have been talking about all the TF2 events coming up, the fact that there is more opportunities to compete in Europe than ever with the league beginning again, and these Razor Cups happening twice a week, as well as the Buttnose Cups. Saichu's cooking up even more cups that will blow your mind, and that means we're going to have more and more games to cast. So anyone out there who fancies themselves, particularly as a cameraman, I would say, but also as a caster, if you are interested in supporting competitive Team Fortress 2 and working with Team Fortress TV, you know, shoot me a PM, add me on Steam. Well, you might be able to add me on Steam. I need to delete some people. Saichu, sorry, you're gone. But yeah, definitely get involved. Ali's going to cast a few games with us this season, right?
Right.
Right?
Right.
Right?
Depending on feedback. People might not want me back.
Twitch chat can be a cool mistress, you know,
I like the tricast. I like the tricast. I can phase out for like 10 whole minutes and come back, and then people haven't noticed them being gone.
You know what we need to do is bring back Pledge and Scully.
Mm.
That's a casting duo for the ages.
And DJ Seabear.
I actually thought that Pledge and Comedian were the better combo.
I couldn't tell the difference.
Two dotsies. I'm being highlighted on the Twitch chat here by Kratos. I'm not sure what it is. I think he wants us to go and cast the cup from the first round, but we have to finish what we started here with the TF2 pickup open rumble.
Maybe Kratos should give us some insight into what on earth how on earth he created such a mishmash of a mix team for the Fragfest as well. It was like the first team created, and it has Atomic, F2 himself. It's such an odd team.
He's making F2 a new
and
team.
Who else? Carry on. That sounds like a lethal team.
Who else was on that roster? It was some of the crazy people.
Hold on there.
Captain.
I've got it.
Yeah, Captain and
someone. Zub, Bash, Zub, yeah. Kratos, Atomic, F2.
Okay, that's pretty lethal.
And Kratos is back playing Demoman, you know, he's tried his hand at Medic pretty successfully. Managed to finish 5th in the league last season, but his run on Scout the season before that wasn't so hot. But now he's back on his main class, I would say, Demoman. Just seeing in chat here as well, Raptor says, bring Arcs and Beta back, and yes, I would love to see those guys casting some games.
That was so good to watch at I-55.
I don't know what their real-world commitments are like, but like every season, I ask them, do they want to cast? This could be the season, guys. They might be riding the I-55 hype straight into the matchmaking hype. Come back, Arcs and Beta.
They never lose it either. They're just as good as they were before. It's crazy.
Yeah, they've got a great natural chemistry, you know, they are good friends in real life. That shines through. Whereas it's very obvious that I fucking detest Saichu every time we cast, you know.
This is the last time I ever work with you.
Run back to Gex, you little bitch.
Oh god. It's the little bits of drama that make it all worth living.
I'm sorry. Kratos corrects me, I said 5th, I meant 4th. I just was trying to compute in my mind that there's only 3 playoff spots. So Dogs finished 4th.
How did they
season.
Finish
4th
in ETFL and then 9th at I-55?
I don't know, there's some sort of dissonance there for sure. Maybe Kratos wants to explain that in Twitch chat.
What? There are two American teams. That's just like, that's just between 6th and 9th. Come on, dude.
Yeah,
not that bad.
No, that's appalling. Come on, they lost the Saints. They nearly lost the Crack Clan.
They lost the Saints. That's yeah. If you lose the Saints, you know, you're part of an elite club. They haven't ever gotten many wins in their league career. So like,
they've got wins in league career. It's just LAN. They always sort of the last team in invite brackets and get stomped. Or at least that was the case at what was it before I-52.
Alice in TF2 asks, just wondering, does anybody even like Admirable?
Bible thump admirable.
Sorry,
bless him.
Sorry, guys.
Ah, God. Right, well, we should be starting fairly soon. I don't know what the delay is here. The Millennium League team is delaying the proceedings.
Trying to put Thundercock off his game.
I think they are. Commander Thundercock's going to have to go for a Thunder Break in a minute and rejuvenate himself. Pop a Viagra.
Let us take a moment to consider the Millennium Legends roster. We haven't cast any of their games yet, but Pigeon is a name that's familiar to me. He must play pickups. I recognise that name.
Yeah, yeah. I recognise that guy as well. I recognise Kampfkex as well for some reason.
Do you think Rogue 36 is actually Tech? Just with the least subtle name.
There's a large potential. Maybe it's just someone who lives right next to Tech.
Oh, yeah.
This is the area code.
Chateau Rude or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Le Berrichon.
Chateau.
Le
Berrichon. Trans-East, baby.
There's a lot of fantastic names coming out on this Millennium League roster, but I don't know. I think the debate is that they're trying to find like a Merc, a stand-in for their pocket, I think, who had to leave for some reason or something. He readied up and then had to go.
Do you think I
so
can get in
he disappeared. Yeah, maybe this is your big debut.
My big debut on the stage.
As pocket.
Can we email? Why am I saying email? Can we Steam message them?
Just add them.
I think they already have somebody, in fact.
Saito's tournament admin, he can just add you. Join.
Yeah, just add me. Quick.
They are trying to grab somebody in. They're getting him in. Let me see. Astrudos. That's the name of the guy. Astrudos is the name of the person going to be flooding in here and saving Millennium Legends from a default loss and they're getting knocked out. But the Rebels are going to have to take this up three maps if Commander Thundercock wants his killstreak kits. I don't know whether they could do it.
This is like the bubble game here, you know. The final, both teams already had a fallback of at least some prizes, but one team is leaving empty-handed here, and with the score already being one map in favor of Millennium Legends, right? They won Gullywash
63.
Mm-hmm. Aye. Thundercock is, you know. He's running on empty here, man. He's been ridden raw all day. He's just... I hope he has it in him. I hope he has a few spurts of greatness left.
I think his stamina's up to it.
I hope so. Come on, Thundercock.
Hope he hasn't climaxed.
Break through the burn. No pain, no gain. Chafe your way to a bronze medal. Let's go. Six players now on the team. Astrudos has arrived.
Here comes Astrudos to save us all from the agony of waiting for this game to begin. Let's hope for something slightly more entertaining than another 5-0.
We're scraping the bottom of the barrel here for, you know, Commander Thundercock puns? I don't know. Maybe just give up on that altogether. See what comes naturally. Don't try too hard, guys. Oh, we're live. We're live! Thank you.
Hello? What? Oh, we are indeed. We are indeed live with our first mid here. I'm going to be watching early and Commander Thundercock actually as they go aggressive around this closet area, but Hawk is in as well. Hitting some players back in that house area, but Pigeon and Embrace are the first casualties, and that Demoman pick is really going to hurt them for Sins. And Kampkex both were so weak there, but it's still kind of a fairly even fight, but everybody from Millennium Legends has been pinned back in that house area, and Paprika's behind them. He might give them the squeeze. Oh, I know he was.
He got called out there. Somebody must have spotted him on the death cam, because Rogue 36 actually had the stickies preset for him. It's going to be an Uber versus Uber battle here, but man advantage for Millennium Legends, and they are coming straight in here. They are hungry for some Thundercock.
Thundercock looks like he might give it to them, actually. He's just poking from that window. See if he wants to go into this fight. The Uber is actually not coming out from either team yet. Finally, the force is there. Just the pressure Rebels proving to be too much. The counter does come out, but there's terrible positioning at the moment for Rebels. They can't actually get much from this. There's Kampkex, the soldier, who's back in Haunter, and he's just wreaking havoc in this house. They can't get any positioning there, and he's going to keep going forward. Embrace the demo man, it's down to 50. He gets blasted back, and Embrace 14 HP. He's going to get out just okay. There were some other frags exchanged slightly in this fight, but they're actually pushed back Rebels all the way to last, despite like both teams being quite far away from Uber, so I think they can contest this, but it looks like they're just gonna chill for now. They've got Paprika behind.
Here he comes. He's not gonna give the game away. He's gonna go for the block. He jumps up to contest four cents, but Campkick sees it and tries to help out. Paprika on four health, jumps up, drops and gets the pills. Somehow he's still alive here. He's taking so much fire, but nobody's there to work on that distraction. Early is close to the roller door, but decides to go back to last. They want to play with five here. 14 seconds before Paprika's back on the field. But they're also a significant Uber disadvantage, 25%. That's plenty to push on.
They're going to be moving forward now and have almost got their Uber charge up. 94% in the upper lobby. They're going to be going for that top left push, I think. They're going to be leading it forward. That's just their pocket. They need to be moving fairly quickly. Jeps are still on 80%. No, they're letting this opportunity slip away from them. I think they are. They're going to wait for Jeps to get his Uber up. A bit of a missed opportunity there. But let's see how they decide to trade these Ubers.
Red did lose their advantage there. 10 seconds they had on that Uber, but just didn't push with it. I'm not sure they could have known, though. There was just, they did pop earlier on mid, but that's quite a way to think back to if you're trying to keep track of these kind of things, especially in the heat intense of this game, this kind of game with what's at stake on the line. It is just going to be such a long, drawn-out thing here. Early, still on that pyro, despite the fact it's even Nubis now, I kind of suggest he went back and switched off, because you only, like, mainly want to be going pyro when you're at disadvantage and want to draw out their Uber for as much as possible. But if he just goes down straight away to this Uber, and then they trade, then it's still going to be even game, except with one player down, so... I don't know, I think he should be changing back here. What do you think?
If he can keep the players in, it makes sense, but if he keeps the players out, well, he's just like... He's missing an opportunity to actually kill them, which is what you want to do, so you can get the man advantage and push, but... Yeah, I would... I prefer to see the scout up, because you can do more... You can react more quickly, but both teams just trying to figure out what we want to do. The ball is firmly in the court of Millennium Legends, though. They have four control points under their possession. They're looking to get that last one and get a round on the board. They're just trying to find that opening.
Well, Thundercock's on the rifle as well, so there's no scouts actually on the board here. He takes his first shot onto Rogue 36, doesn't manage to connect it. It looks like they're going to take the Uber through, and he's going to get eliminated immediately. Early has done nothing so far. He drops down too late. He finally gets Ubered and just counters it completely, but he gets dropped by the Ubers too last as there's pressure on the point, which means all the Rebels have to turn around. Campex is on the floor trying to do damage, but the entirety of the Rebels team is there, and it's only going to be Rogue left alive in the end. That was turned out to be a nice defense.
It did indeed.
They
managed to get it, and Rogue was miles out of there by the end of it. He's going to stay alive, and they're still running that sniper. Oh, sorry, they've decided to run a sniper. It was actually the defending team previously. Pigeon is going to be on that sniper glass, posting up just by the closet area, taking a look over at Risa, where he might get a sight onto a few of these players. Paprika now just going to take an air shot and go straight into his sightline.
What a
nice air headshot there onto Paprika. Great stuff there, teaming up the players from Millennium Legends to air shot and then air headshot and destroy him.
Still 0-0 here. Only 5 minutes played. But Millennium Legends with a map in hand here in this best of three. Currently, Kampfkick's down. He's just respawning. So it will be 6-on-6. And Uber charges apiece. But with Pigeon on sniper, you know, it's tricky for them to push. Like, they can't chase frags. It's a slow class. So probably we're going to see them sit back here and allow Rebels to initiate the next fight. Oh, they found four sense in the house there. He grabs the kit, but it's not going to be enough to save him. And he just gets manhandled there. Paprika's in, he's putting pressure on Pigeon. He's eliminated the sniper threat briefly, but Pigeon is now on choke. The Ubers have been popped off here. And Rebels try to do the ninja vanish, they end up losing 3, 4, 5 players.
Another air headshot coming up from Pigeon. He is just completely destroying these soldier jumps right now. I don't think he's hit anything on the ground yet. He's only hit things in the air.
Saito, what are you having for dinner?
What am I having for dinner?
Yeah.
I have no idea. I haven't even thought that far ahead yet. I don't know whether we're even going to get a break for dinner. I'm working me like an absolute workhorse. Embrace looking off this lower left entrance. And Campkex and Rogue eating more spam than I'm going to be eating hot meals today. As they move into upper lobby with two down, but they have a new advantage. They can afford to wait for these spawners, actually. And Pigeon switches back off to the scout. Early might have been caught in as well. If they get that frag, they can move. Oh, they should just go anyway. You just need to go. Use this opportunity when you have an Uber advantage, please. Millennium Legends, use your Uber advantage. You have another 10 seconds to use it. Here they go, top left demo and the pocket. They knock early off, actually. That's really bad for him, but he still gets a reflect. And they may be able to use this Uber. No, Jebs has got it in time, even though early was on Pyro. They've found frags everywhere, actually. It's still a 4v3. If they can re-push from the top entrance, they can might still be able to do something. Pigeon comes in with the meat shot. It's going to be able to take down Jebs if early gets taken down here. Forces on the point. And the score 1-0 to Millennium Legends.
Early looked like his sensitivity was a little bit too low for playing Pyro. He was trying to track that sky around, but he just bamboozled him there. That will be first blood to Millennium Legends. They've gotten around on the board. They're looking good to take the second map as well. And I'm taking a look at Rogue as he comes out. He pre-fires Embryos, manages to tag him a little bit as well there. But on the blue side, though, Paprika's ready for the big bomb. He's trying to come in high. But it seems like Millennium Legends don't even want to contest this mid fight too much. They've just all sat back in house and choked. They're not really getting in onto the middle, and they paid the price. Getting schooled right now by Rebels.
Pigeon did a beautiful job there. He completely saved the situation. He took down a soldier and a scout, both of which were right on his medic. The rest of their team were dying on mid, but Pigeon single-handedly there saved it from being lost of a second point to a complete uber disadvantage. So well played to him.
Sideshow had to step out there. Commander Thundercock, though, he is relentless. He never rests. He's going to cap Spire and is now just scouting out the lobby here for his teammates. He can give the intel that there is no forward hold in effect. It's free admission here to Red last, but the defensive setup is going to be Pigeon on Sniper. That's their gamble. They're already coming in.
Yeah, early just ran in there for no apparent reason and forced the Uber from his own medic to try and keep him alive. The Uber has come back out now from Millennium Legends, but their frags have actually just gone one either way so far. But once again, Millennium Legends find themselves on the floor, so if they wanted to push back in here, I think Rebels can do it. And they do send their scouts in together, still pressuring that position on the floor. It's up to Pigeon entirely. He does get one more kill, and the spawn actually does come in for Forsyth. Forsyth now running into main, Pigeon and Forsyth clutching this situation so hard. It's just Paprika left in the forward lobby. He's going to find himself in a one-on-one, just spamming down those stairs. But in the edge, and Pigeon comes in, helps out his boy Forsyth, and the scouts completely save it there.
Pigeon on a 4k, he was activating beast mode on that last defense. Now it's times 4 on the Spire. The heavies are just getting here. We see early playing Sniper, he takes one shot and then retreats immediately. He's going to play super defensive from the back of middle here. He's on his own train, in fact. But as the game state sits, it's a slight uber advantage here, 25% for Millennium Legends. But they have the momentum, having been reclaiming the Spire. They push forward from last, and now they're just taking a peek into middle. They're trying to clear sticky traps. They're waiting for that charge, but they need to be almost getting a position right now as they hit like 85-90% if they want to make the most of this. They're being hesitant though. Now they're trying to go house. Looks like they want to make that house push. 80% right now for Jeps. He could get that charge. He just needs to kite for about 5 seconds here. He's got it into spawn. He's already lost Paprika though. He's got no healing target, so the uber charge won't be coming up anytime soon. Now he's re-hooked up with his teammates here. Both soldiers.
No soldiers.
What can they do to get in?
Yeah, they can't do anything. If they had crits there, that would have been a perfect re-engage situation, but you can't afford that. So, like, you need to... I don't know if he was telling his team and they weren't listening or he wasn't vocalizing the fact, but he was, like, 5 seconds off. If he had it there, he could have saved both of his soldiers when they were jumping back towards him. But as it happens, now the rest of his team has been caught out on the stone bridge early on Sniper. It's completely out of position. And there's two scouts, Pigeon and Forsyth, they're all the way behind. They've taken out Bohawk together, and Forsyth is running around lobby while Kampkex has now joined Pigeon on balcony. He's down to 11 HP. Rogue takes down Paprika coming in. And yeah, the scouts for Legends are just like winning this game for them at the moment, in my opinion.
Nice pull there from Jeps to save themselves from a big meat shot. Saichu!
Can early and Commander Thundercock put up the same kind of battle as Pigeon and Foreskins? It really is the question. The scouts running away with it, as you say, but I believe in these guys. Yeah, we've got the pyro defense, the classic pyro defense again. This time it's Commander Thundercock instead of early. He gets one reflect, he's gonna juggle people up a little bit, gets a flare shot as well. This guy's a monster on the pyro, absolutely on fire. Gonna get a frag onto Astrodos as well, and this is a great defense here from Rebels.
Early is giving chase here. He sees the medic is real. He's trying to pistol him down, but He's actually... What? The Scotsman's Skullcutter comes out there from Rogue? Is that weapon even viable? Does it not make you slower? Or is that only when you have it out? I don't know. I'm gonna have to rethink my Demoman game, guys. Mind blown right now, but early is down. But it's a tricky situation here for Rebels. They are a man down, but they do have that Uber advantage. It seems like they're gonna wait.
They need to use this, but they've got to be scared of the Pigeon Sniper. He's in the same position he was before. Last time they engaged, their soldiers got plucked out of the air, making the clever decision to Uber them before they even jumped this time. Fabrique is in the air though. Pigeon misses the shot, and Pigeon actually defensively backs out towards Choke, but Fabrique is completely in their face, but he's against three people. I don't know what he tried to hope to expect there. Kampkex is still far forward as Pigeon hits his shot onto the opposing demo man. Kampkex now finds himself in the middle of the opposing team, doesn't manage to take down Jeps, who hits him with an arrow before Thundercock keeps him alive. The aggression does come forward though. Now it's
early
just Thundercock
on the back,
early. I don't think he's going for the backup. I think he's going to go for the medic play. There's no one spotting him yet. No one spotted him. He's on bridge. The sniper finally spots him. Did he hit him? I think he hit him there.
He stunned him, yeah.
Completely killed his forward momentum and stopped him doing anything there early. And now they're looking like they want to push it once again. They do have both of those scout frags. The Uber is going to come in as well. I cannot see a defense coming out here. In a thousand years, they should be able to... Oh, they're not getting any fractures there. They're not getting anything with this. This is a disastrous push here from Millennium Legends. Absolutely appalling from them. But the save from Kampkex, certainly possible. He's in a full lobby. He wants to get something done. He's dancing around. Takes down early, but that's going to be a defense from the Rebels to keep this at 1-0.
Oh, wow. Embrace drops out the window, but gets rushed by Pigeon. Pigeon's going to last. He's trying to take a fight with the mighty Thundercock. Thundercock on one health, but manages to win the duel. Huge plays coming out there. Misses every shot at the beginning, but the pistol was too strong. Pigeon down.
Yeah, that play by Pigeon, and also the fact that that last player going down from Millennium Legends did take out the only scout on the team. Thundercock, if you remember, was a pyro. They had no chance of capping that spire with just a couple of soldiers, Demoman and Medic. As we see early now, is taking the onus on himself to take the one-on-one. He's against Pigeon, down to one HP. He's surely going to go down though. Yeah, doesn't live up to his brother Thundercock on the one HP plays. So
shenanigans.
Oh, is this Camp the first? Is this the first spy we've seen? It is. He's running up the stairs now. Nobody spotted him. Nobody's even looking for him. The medic stood on the stairs. He gets him.
Boom!
Uber drop. He almost gets the soldier as well.
Well, surely a backstab. Kampkex, Rob. He does get that all-important medic pick though, but...
It's beautiful.
Uber charge now available for Meh Israel. They are two players down though. Oh, he's Ubered really early here in top lobby. He's gonna drop a scout as well. Everybody's trying to get involved, but... Currently it's only these three classes here forward. The retreat's being cut off by early on one HP. Manages to drop onto the lower ground, but does put damage into the medic. May Israel down. Astruda's going to join him, and Rogue as well gets cleaned up.
Can't tell if Rogue thought he had a different weapon out. Maybe he doesn't have view models on, but he was running around there with his Scotsman Skullcutter, trying to click on people and failing completely. We do actually see Pigeon trying to hide, waiting for this push out. Embrace is chucking stickies around, trying to set up, but it doesn't look like they're actually going to push out, so Pigeon's hide will be in vain. As I say that, Early completely... Oh no, Pigeon gives away his position just the last moment, and now Early's going to take the fight and completely destroy him.
I'm just watching Kampkex.
Oh my god, he got through. Kampkex. Nobody saw him.
He's just been hiding there ever since the last
Paprika
push.
Knows.
Everyone knows he's there, but nobody's dealing with him. And so he's just wandering up and down. Oh, Commander Thundercock on the prowl is going to take that one.
Penetrate it.
That's a 2-kill streak.
Goes down as well. Slayed that 4 cents. Oh, Pigeon's on the back half now, though.
Half,
nobody's
there
to contest. Nobody's this
around.
Is a done deal. Oh my god.
They were repelling push after push there, but... They just couldn't manage to actually push out from last and avoid the backcap situation. You know, you have to be really quick and slick with those pushes out from Badlands last, because unless you get the cap time really quickly, you're leaving yourself open so much to that backcap.
We've got 40 minutes left, still only 2-0. Not as one-sided, definitely, as the other finals matches we've seen. But it's going to be up to Rebels to take the initiative here. Kampkex tries to go for the range, but Paprika completely spots him. We get destroyed by Kampkex. He needs Early to help him finish off. But in the meantime, Jet has gone out to Pigeon. Pigeon now on a 2k. Embrace down too much group of classes. He does go down, but he's surely won the team fight. But Rogue is alone now, and it's only just Astrudos and Israel coming in. But the Skullcutter gets a kill. And
That might have been enough to get the kill as the bomb comes in by Bohawk onto Mezreal. 20 HP, 4 HP as Strudos keeps him alive. Beautiful pocket play there.
Shoot floor, kill Thundercocks. Well played, Strudos. Little bit of a bomb coming in from Paprika though. He's in onto Mezreal, he drops onto the low ground. Paprika's going to jump out though, he realised that he wasn't going to get anything done there. He's looking for a big arrow though. Hamkex jumps in, he's trying to catch that frag, but actually gifts one to early. And there is action happening in the blue house now as Forsense moves forward. He's looking for a frag but doesn't find one. And in fact, our red team with uber advantage here, Millennium Legends, are a man down and they're kind of in two minds. Looks like they want to make the play on Resup though. They're sending in Astrudis to kill up Paprika, but Pigeon's going to catch him at long range there with like a single pellet, gets the frag, and now the uber gets popped off. This is carnage.
It is indeed, yep, has 75%, but the rest of it, great play from Boic! And teaming up there with early to get that frag onto the medic, but they need to stay alive a little bit more. Jebs has got nobody to connect with. He's only defended at the moment by Embrace, and if they get somebody going aggressive, that demon. The double donk airshot to slam Kamkex into the ground where he blows himself up. That was insane!
The end-run in chat from Kamkex.
Oh my
he
god.
He appreciates.
That was incredible. What an airshot. I don't think I've seen a double donk airshot before, but that was brilliant.
And it is now Paprika once again moving on to Mezreal as Pigeon takes that embrace on the re-engage, but it doesn't matter because Paprika's under the point doing work. Early has now replaced his former teammate under the point after he gets taken down. Commander Thunderstrike not having enough. Pigeon doesn't like Pigeon taking all the glory on the sniper role. They're going to force the uber now. Kamkex is going to go down. This looks like it's a 1 point for Rebels. Commander Thundercock saving his team from Grace. It's going to be a sniper versus sniper, but Pigeon takes down Commander Thundercock. He's going to move on to the point. Get it? As Bohawk tries to jump now to take down Pigeon, but Fornsense is having none of it. As Rogue jumps in and Pigeon gets him on the exit. This is beautiful sniper play here from Pigeon.
Every single time there's a soldier in the air, Pigeon's hitting it. He can only hit body shots on things on the ground, but here comes early. Early in for the flank. Gets 50 damage onto Mezreal and trying to finish off that kill. But on 20 HP gets decapitated by the axe plays. There's great potential here for the Rebels to get all these frags though. Everyone's so weak here from Millennium Legends, but they're just not focusing frags. They're not playing together.
Thundercock wants in on this. He sees the opportunity, but wisely backs off as there's the entire team grouped around the side of this spire. They're waiting for Pigeon to respawn, which is probably wise given his influence so far. And it looks just like Rebels were trying to protect that trash area, but oh my gosh. Early is the sticky trap. These 1v1s. Now with demos as well as scouts.
Direct hit action going on here from Bohawk as well. He is trying to catch someone out, but Mezreal actually doesn't make it through the choke point. Medic down right now for Millennium Legends, and their 2-0 lead is in danger of being eroded as Rebels have arisen. Just the back caps on though. Pigeon, the man of the hour, is going huge here. He's capped Spire, he's looking to go last. He's going to be in a 1v1 versus Paprika here. Actually, early's going to spawn in 1 second as well. He's decided to go back, realizes that is not the optimal play to make. He's trying to block Spire here, but Commander Thunderstruck smacks him on the chin, knocks him down there onto the low ground.
Jeps died with 98% there. It was really unfortunate. Just lucky his team had the ability to clean up after them fact, but it's going to be Mezreal, despite the fact we're coming out with a 50% advantage. Teams both opted to move away from the sniper, saying that Pigeon has gone back to it now. Commander Thundercock realizes he's been outclassed and trying to go for the scout play, but yeah, I don't know. This game is so much more tense. I'm glad we opted for Carthus. I'm glad. Well, how are you feeling?
The
about
direct
you?
Hit smacks the medic there, Mezreal, for 60 damage, and juggled him up in the air just for a moment. These direct hits are coming in thick and fast. And the double down potential here as well from Embrace as he throws in those loose cannons. Paprika's the one to die though on the flank, taken down by Forsense. And everybody else here for the Rebels really bunched up, so nobody really covering Resup. There isn't actually a threat there at the moment, but they need to spread themselves out to make sure that they're covering all of those areas. And that might just open something up, maybe a little route that Pigeon can take to get a key priority pick.
Early takes a one-on-one again and wins. This is crazy. And yeah, Red have
had the Uber for about 20 seconds there before Blue did, but they just couldn't make use of it because of that sniper. Early going down this roll literally meant just they had no mobility on the flank. Pigeon's now trying to take these shots, but he's getting pressured from early. This is really nice aggression. It's coordinated with the Soldier Bomb as well. They need to get something from it, though. His Rohawk's coming too now. The Uber, it does get forced eventually, but they just haven't got much at all. Thunderstruck is in the front line. He does actually force out the Uber. Well played by him. Thunderstruck, Thundercock. And now Jex is going to be pressured away. Kampkex is fine. It's embraced on the point by himself. Thundercock comes in, can't make anything work. Kampkex does pick up Jex from behind. It is just embraced. He's going to be Kampkex from behind. Be like, WTF, where did you come from? He gets launched across the map, tries to get stabbed. But Mezrael comes with the Ubersaw, chucks himself up to 37%. And now this is going to look brutal for a last push.
7 minutes, 30 seconds on the clock. Still a 2-0 lead here for Millennium Legends, our red team. They are also 1-0 up in this series, this best of three in this bronze final. The loser of this is going to leave empty-handed in this tournament. Oh, Pigeon walks in through Roller Door and sees Commander Thundercock up top. Going to dome him and now moves forward looking for more heads. But he sees Paprika setting up a level 1 sentry gun top right. He's going to be able to relay that information to his team as they get ready to push here with the Uber. I hear a Conch being blown as well. They're going to come in hot and fast. Sideshow's been triggered. Conch and Uber at the same time. Madness!
Absolute madness. It doesn't make any sense. It makes me so annoyed. But there we go. There's the round. And they extend their lead to 3-0. Commander Thundercock with two dominations there. Top of his scoreboard apart from Jeps. I'm going to be watching him on this mid. I think he needs to go even bigger. He needs to increase his girth massively if he wants to carry his team to a victory.
And 6 minutes left, it's still entirely possible, but I think if they completely sway the game, the best we can look at the moment is Golden Cap. And oh yeah, we want to see a Golden Cap, but Paprika wants it too. He's coming. He's got the first frag, but they're moving on to point really well at the moment, but it's entirely possible for Legends to reclaim this, and it is Ashudos coming out. They've got no advantage whatsoever, so I'm not sure why they're doing this. Pure DM ability, and Ashudos is going to get right in the face of Jax, going to take him down. There's still favorable numbers for Rebels here.
Thundercock takes a direct hit right to the
direct hit is brutal. Say that again.
Right, yeah. In the jab, say.
Yeah, Thundercock got Thundershock. It was unbelievable. Right down the shaft.
Oh, Paprika, he's behind enemy lines right now with Bohawk as well. Can he do it? Paprika, can he do it? No, I'm trying to crowbar in more spicy jokes here, spicy memes for you guys. But Paprika's going to retreat and regroup with his team on middle. Oh, he's been found by Pigeon though. Man down. Two down actually, in fact, for Rebels.
Nobody.
Millennium Legends.
Nobody in Twitch chat picked up on the KN, you knew it. Either they just disapprove or you're just too meta for everyone.
Either way,
Embrace is going to get put in and taken down by the pipe / cannonball ability. Paprika is once again the person who's going to be diving in. He plucked up Mezrael but can't hit him. And it's just going to be Rebels taking the initiative. Kampkex gets completely caught out there in the complete wrong position. The health of Mezrael is going to mean that the rest of his team has to back all the way off. Pigeon once again back on scout, and we're not going to make him this sniper plays anymore. But early isn't going to win the 1v2 on the flank. Thundercock is up already on that spire. They're going to completely deny. He can just rain down shots now. I'm not sure why Legends are trying to take this. They are going to force their own Uber, but they're way off from... they do get him!
Jeps goes down, forcing on a 2k, but stealing Pigeon's frags, I think. Now early is going to kill off Pigeon there in the middle, but Pigeon just killed off Embrace as well, so Demoman down. A lot of momentum here for Rebels. They're looking to get their first round on the board here on Badlands. They have Spire, both scouts running in. It's going to be early from bottom right, Thundercock.
Soldier above the point there, Soldier above the point. He hasn't seen him at all.
So unfortunate there, the bodies of early and Thundercock go limp. And the respawn queue is just about to spit them back out. Here come the scouts from Rebels back on the scene once again. They do have a tiny Uber advantage, but they're not going to push with it. They haven't been pushing with any of their 70% Uber advantages in some situations. So for them to use a 10 or 15 is a bit optimistic, I think. They're just going to take control of upper lobby here and maybe just feel people out. Pigeon's still sat in this forward respawn, though. don't know quite what he's up to. He's maybe thinking about flanking people from drop down at some point. Well, looks like the play that he's going for. He's going to go up, drop down, and think about coming into upper lobby. He's going to try and flank everybody. Whiffs everything and runs back.
Panicked. He's and coming in though again.
The Ubers are going to be traded though, he's going to be miles out, he's only going to come in after the Ubers here. But it doesn't even matter, Commander Thundercock on the point, capping it off. 3-1, they can actually do this.
Believe boys, believe.
3 minutes on the clock, we're going to go to the fifth middle here, 2 rounds, the difference. Come on Thundercock, Twitch chat is rooting for you, spam your ASCII penises in there, 8 eagles, eagles, eagles D for the Thundercock. Both scouts playing on the low ground here, in fact, for Rebels. They managed to bait Pigeon forward and Embrace combines there, hits him with the loose cannon, and things are looking good here for Rebels on this mid fight. They managed to engineer a two-man difference. They're probably going to be able to kill off Kampkex as well. Another frag. And Medic down, all importantly there, Met Israel is dead, so huge opportunity
momentum
here for Jibs.
Absolute momentum shift. 2 minutes left. They can push this one forwards. They're going to have full Uber as well. They just need to make sure that Jeps isn't caught in any of these sticky situations. Admirable Ali. This is your worst nightmare. The pressure situation for a medic. You have to use this Uber. The time is ticking down. Where do you go from? What do you do?
Main. Straight down main. Oh, they're going to go
straight
bottom
down
right,
main.
Actually.
No. They're taking their time. Moving into upper lobby. They want to go top left. Straight into the meat.
Got to bring a scout in here. They're going to lead with early. And Bohawk, they're trying to find that medic pick, but any frag would be good here. Early gets out of range of the life-saving Uber. He's gone down, but they find Astrudos. Four Sense is playing heavy. He's only got 100 health, though. Will die pretty
they're
easily.
They're on the point!
Nice!
1:36. They need a round to force this one to a golden cap here. Commander Thundercock now with 3 dominations. Absolutely
all
carrying the team.
All aboard the comeback train. Commander Thundercock will be your conductor.
He's issuing tickets to the spawn queue. Let's go.
Commander Thundercock going to initiate the comeback. And here he comes under Valley. He's going to be attempting to take that low 1v1. He goes down to about half health here, but with Pigeon and Kampkex down, things are really heating up. They can push across the point. They have an opportunity. Early's distracting everybody. They need to make the most of this. With 53 seconds left, they can push it forwards. Rogue is chilling on the balcony, but he's going to get out in resub. Actually, he might be caught by Rohawk. Look how weak Rogue is. 6 health, but they're not going to find that frag. Instead, just pushing around the choke area.
They don't have time to take it this slowly either, though. Like, they're spending so long. Rogue distracted them for a good 5 seconds there. And now,
they're
being too aggressive, but they get the frag! The frag on Israel. Bohawk is so weak, and Thundercock's just dancing around, completely distracting them. They're going
to
lose that frag.
They need to go forwards, though. Jeps needs to not be afraid to use Zuba. But he's dropped his pocket. This is not looking good. 19 seconds, they absolutely have to start the cap right now. Early's getting on the point. He's getting spammed by Rogue. But yeah, they have
beautiful.
Him down.
That's beautiful by Early. He needs to win this 1v1.
They have to flip the last.
This is totally on. This is so on. Stop
they
toying with it,
Rich. What are we doing?
What are they doing?
What has happened here? They've given up. They had that in the palm of their hands and they crushed it. And unfortunately, the hopes and dreams of the Rebels getting smashed by the Millennium Legend Galactic Empire.
Commander Thundercock, 3 doms, though, you know.
Commander Thundercock goes home with nothing, Admirable. Goes home doms. With nothing.
He's got the people. He's the people's champion. He's the new people's champion of Team Fortress 2.
The golden boy of gaming.
I'm not sure who was the boy, but he's the people's champ of TF2.
Best name since Shit Wizard, Commander Thundercock has made a big splash today.
Great stuff from this third and fourth place team. The Millennium Legends take the third place and Rebels in fourth. So they go home with some tasty Killstreak kits. As I said, Rebels go home with nothing. They get nothing. But that wraps up the TF2 pickup Open Rumble for now. We saw the what were they called? Quantic Pups, Chaos Pups,
just
chaotic pups. That's the one.
It's going back.
The,
Quantic Pups.
Going back to that last game for a few seconds. Normally on logs we see the soldiers topping the scoreboard for air shots, but in this game, can you guess who was top? It was Pigeon on his sniper rifle with six air shots. He managed. Completely carried his team through that one.
Just before everyone starts to bail, that was the last game of the TF2 pickup Open Rumble number one, that was the bronze match. But as every Wednesday and Sunday, there will be a Gaming Grids TF2 Fragfest EU Cup happening. We're going to jump into the semi-finals. That's going to be in 30 minutes time, an hour if you want. Check in again in half an hour. Everyone's going to take a break right now, Sideshow. I'll authorize it.
Oh, thank you, Marble.
Clock out there. I don't want to be paying you for your break. Stay.